Antiwar.com reports another U.S. drone strike has torn through Dhata Khel in Pakistan's North Waziristan, killing 5 people, all of whom were identified by officials as suspected Taliban, though none of them were actually named. The attack destroyed a house and the 5 people were within. The suspicion of their Taliban appears, as usual, to be based on the idea that anyone the U.S. strikes hit probably was guilty of something. It comes in the wake of another report released warning of large numbers of innocent civilians have been hit in U.S. attacks and then passed off as suspects by Pakistani officials not eager to look deeper into it. That the targets were labeled Taliban specifically also suggests that there is more information sharing with the U.S. and that the drone war is not even nominally focused on high-profile Al-Qaeda-linked targets, but any Taliban they might conceivably find. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. Reuters reports the younger sister of North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has assumed a senior position in the ruling Workers' Party, according to state media on Thursday, consolidating a third generation of Kim family rule in the secretive state. Kim Yo-jong, who is believed to be 27 years old, had previously only been named as a party official, but was rumored to have a managerial role in her brother's government. In a report carried by state news agency KCNA, she was identified today as a vice director of a department within the powerful Central Committee of the ruling Workers' Party. Kim Yo-jong is the only other member of the ruling Kim family known to have an official job within the North Korean government. Her brother is the third-generation Kim to rule North Korea. Kim Jong-un, who is regularly the centerpiece of state propaganda, recently disappeared from state media reports for over a month, prompting speculation about alternative structures of power within the ruling Kim family. For over 35 years, Robertson Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Robertson Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports popular Pakistani actress Veena Malik has been sentenced to 26 years in prison for malicious acts of blasphemy after appearing in a staged wedding scene based on the marriage of the Prophet Muhammad's daughter. The wedding was part of a daytime program created and aired by GOTV. It triggered a sudden wave of controversy in the Islamic community, even though similar scenes had been aired earlier with little or no notice. The ruling by the anti-terrorism court stated the malicious acts of the proclaimed offenders ignited the sentiments of all the Muslims of the country and hurt their feelings, which cannot be taken lightly, and there is need to strictly curb such tendency. Malik, who is currently in Dubai, said she was shocked by the sentence. She told the Times of India, "We are born Muslims, and all I can say is that we have not done any mistakes. We are innocent, and that is why I'm going to Pakistan to face it. It is not a blasphemy in any way." It is unclear if the sentence will actually be enforced. The court order is to be imposed in the city of Gilgit, but control of Gilgit is shared between Pakistan and the India-claimed Kashmir region, so jurisdiction is uncertain. In any case, Malik would have to return to Pakistan to be imprisoned. Malik's husband and the chief executive of the biggest media group in the Asian country were both also sentenced to 26 years. All three were ordered to pay a $13,000 fine, surrender their passports and sell all of their property. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In a dramatic scene last night, a coalition of the nation's damaged women staged a drunken, tear-soaked march on the Capitol just after 2 a.m. Jane Carmichael has more.
Thank you, Brooke. The damaged women began their protest yesterday afternoon, marching on the National Mall at about 4 p.m., and then marching away furious, saying they were done with Congress once and for all. But then they came back again late last night, insisting that someone in Washington listen to them for once. The late-night protests started with tearful apologies, but quickly moved to anger as marchers demanded that Congress pass a bill making it illegal to say you love someone and then up and leave as soon as there's one little problem.
Why are you ignoring us? Stop ignoring us! Why don't you hear me when I talk to you? Wipe the smirk off of your face! No, come back! Come back, because we think that you... We want you to care about us!
I don't need to pay a therapist to tell me I'm unhappy! I know I'm unhappy!
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live. It is the Thanksgiving Day edition of the program. Gobble, gobble. With you in the studio tonight is a very sleepy crew, at least me and Lauren. I don't know about Mark. So Ian, Lauren, Rumpler, and Mark are here. Mark, you had your Thanksgiving dinner a little earlier.
Somewhere around 2.
I had mine around 5, so it's settling in real nice right about now. We're in the Eastern time zone here in New Hampshire. The activists got together today, as they tend to do, at various different parts of the state. As you know, if you've been listening to the show, we moved here as part of the Free State Project, which is an idea of bringing liberty-minded people, people who understand what freedom really means, that you should be free to live your life how you want, so long as you don't harm anyone else. And that in order to be free, you have to allow others to be free. People that get that and who want to actually advance freedom in our lifetime are all coming to the same geographic area, or many of them are, and that is the point of the Free State Project. But for a lot of people, it can be tough leaving family. One of the big objections that we hear when we talk to people about joining the Free State Project is, oh, I can't leave California or Illinois or some other police state hellhole because my family's here. And so for those who actually do manage to leave their families, it can be tough, you know, to come to a new place where your family is not necessarily with you. You know, maybe you left them behind where in the place where you from which you hail. And thankfully, the activist community has solved that problem and has for a number of years. Mark, I think the first year you and I came here, there was a activist Thanksgiving that happened.
Yeah, I think, I don't know. It seems like I had it at, I've had it at several different people's houses and, you know, float around and have a great time.
Yeah, I know it was happening from the very early days. If it wasn't the first year, it was certainly the second year that we were here. But I'm pretty sure it was the first one, because I think they've been doing it ever since people have started moving here. For the Free State Project, it gives people a way who didn't bring a family with them to come together with their fellow activists' family, if you will, and cause sort of like our chosen family in a way, and in order to come together and, you know, enjoy the holiday. And that's what we did today.
Right. It's been a really great time.
The food was great.
Yeah, this is my first Thanksgiving in Keene.
Did you do one last year in Manchester?
Yeah, last year I got to go to Manchester's, and it was so much fun. It was great, but it's nice to actually see my distant relatives this year. This has been a really great Thanksgiving. And if you guys ever get the opportunity to come spend Thanksgiving in New Hampshire somewhere, check out Manch or check out Keene. Get a hold of one of us.
There's always something happening.
Yeah, I mean, if you're ever in the area, just check up with us, whether it's Thanksgiving, any other day. We'd love to have you around.
So I'm grateful for you being here, Lauren and Mark, so thanks for coming in. Aww. And doing a live edition of Free Talk Live, as has been our Thanksgiving tradition here for countless years.
Yeah, I don't think there's too many main radio hosts that are doing shows today.
I don't imagine so, no.
Surely no. Some of them did, you know, had somebody sit in for them or something like that. I mean, I heard Marketplace on NPR had a guest host, but...
Lower competition.
Yeah, they're not really. They don't. It's non-commercial radio. But we try to be here to do a show every single night of the week for you on Free Talk Live.
So we'll continue doing that throughout the holidays as well. Of course, our phones are always open if you want to call in. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Maybe you want to tell us for what it is that you are thankful. You are certainly welcome to do that. And Mark, you were begging me to read this Thanksgiving story. I'm so burnt on it. I mean, it was fun for a couple of years. I've got sort of a slightly different variant on it from LouRockwell.com, which is where the original one came from. The one that we've read year after year, I think, is the one called The Great Thanksgiving Hoax by Richard Maybury. If you search LouRockwell.com Thanksgiving on Google, that's what comes up first. But I wanted to find something else to read just because it was just so long and I'd rather talk about other things.
Yeah, I read a debunking of this the story. But
a debunking of the Thanksgiving hoax story?
Yes, but it basically bunked it. You know, I mean,
they bunked their debunking?
No, the things that they said was mostly like, well, it didn't happen exactly that way, you know, and that kind of thing. So, yeah. It's largely true story.
You mean the Indians weren't happy that we came and took their land and gave us food in return?
Oh no, I didn't take anyone's land.
Squanto,
I'll just let you know.
Squanto was
that's true.
They were there,
ancestors,
and they helped. So yeah, they're around.
So this story by Dick Cheatham at LouRockwell.com.
We've had him on the show.
Really?
Yeah, he does character acting.
He was on this show.
He's been on Free Talk Live. We did him an interview at Porkfest.
Huh.
And he does characters.
Great.
So wow, Ian.
Sit in.
Was I there?
maybe not.
Because sometimes I'm not there at Porkfest. You know, one night or two nights I won't be there.
Oh, goodness.
Okay. So you've had this guy on the show?
Yeah.
He does characters.
Yes.
Great.
So he historical characters. Like, okay. You know, I don't know which ones. Go check out his website.
Like one of those guys who will like go and speak to a group and dress up.
Yeah.
Like, I'm Ben Franklin, kind of thing.
But he's not Ben Franklin. He's He has other historical figures that he thinks are sort of more integral. Important. Yeah. But, you know, okay. He does a great job.
That's, like Calvin Coolidge?
No, not Calvin Coolidge.
That's ringing a little bit of a bell. So anyway, this is sort of, I think, a more truncated version of the story. We should get the concept out without going into great detail, and then you can, you know, do your own research. So it's titled The Real First Thanksgiving, written over a decade ago. No, I'm not talking about the Pilgrims who, as stated in their own Mayflower Compact, sailed to the northern parts of Virginia in 1620. There was no Massachusetts colony yet. That well-known Pilgrim Thanksgiving came years after the one I'm talking about. I refer to a Thanksgiving celebrated further south in Virginia on the north bank of the James River in early December of 1619. The charter for the new Berkeley plantation commanded that the day of the safe arrival of the settlers shall be, quote, yearly and perpetually kept holy as a day of Thanksgiving, unquote. We tend to be fascinated by firsts and biggests, etc. No doubt, there have been many Thanksgivings in many cultures for many reasons. The one at Berkeley was certainly not the first. Those who arrived in Virginia with Captain John Smith in 1607 had given thanks for their safe arrival. However, the settlers at Berkeley were ordered to make their Thanksgiving perpetual. They had a great deal for which to give thanks. Certainly high on the list was safe arrival in Virginia. They were also lucky to have arrived in a colony in which a miniature parliament called the General Assembly had just been established the previous summer. This was literally the introduction of representative government into European America. The primitive yet strong and growing seeds of individual liberty and rights for the common man, which came from the Magna Carta and from the English common law, were now permanently established in Virginia soil. Another thing for which those settlers could be thankful was that the deadly common storehouse, aka socialist, system, had lost favor and was rapidly being replaced by private ownership of land for the common man. Pocahontas' husband John Rolfe wrote in 1616 of, quote, every man sitting under his fig tree in safety, gathering and reaping the fruits of their labors with much joy and comfort. Rolfe, who served in that first General Assembly in 1619, was the great hero who saved the fledgling democracy through his entrepreneurial efforts with tobacco. His friend Ralph Hamer described the classic failure of socialism in Virginia, writing, quote, for formerly, when our people were fed out of the common store and labored jointly in the manuring of the ground and planting corn, glad was the man that could slip from his labor. Nay, the most honest of them in a general business would not take so much faithful and true pains in a week as he will now do in a day. Can you translate that, Mark?
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, this is obvious, right? Like, so if we all, you know, you get together 50 people who have to work together to build, to work the land, and then everybody eats off that food. Well, the laziest guy is going.
Oh, my back!
Right. That guy or gal, whoever that person, whoever they might be, is going to duck out as often as possible. And they're going to duck out enough times that people are going to get tired of asking them.
You know, guys, I got a cake in the oven. I'll be back in a little while.
They're going to duck out so often that they're basically going to get away with it all of the time because mm-hmm. people don't want to police them. It's as much work to make them work.
To make them do something.
As it is to have them, that you get out of them. They're just not worth it. So then that person goes. And then the second laziest person's like, well, I don't want to do this if
this.
They're not doing it.
Yeah.
And then
they still get to eat.
This is the problem with collective effort.
Right.
I mean, if everybody's got skin in the game, they can't possibly just sit around and do nothing.
This is why communism doesn't work. This is why socialism doesn't work.
This is why the U.S. federal government doesn't work.
Well, we'll come back with more here in moments, but that is essentially the apparently true story of the real first Thanksgiving was they were giving thanks because they finally had a surplus of food thanks to private ownership of what they were working on. More coming up.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you, or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
Yeah!
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Live Thanksgiving Day edition of the program. We're here to take your calls as we always are. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, or you can join us via Skype, as our next caller will be doing. Our Skype username is lrn.fm.
I'm thankful for advertisers that help us pay the bills around here. And one of those advertisers is New Age Auto Sales at newageautosales.com. And what they want to do is they want to be the Bitcoin auto dealer. They have their own rental fleet. And what they do is they cycle out the cars out of their rental fleet. They're well-maintained and have been cared for in a fashion that, of course, you know, anybody's going to do with the cars in their business. And when they sell them, you don't have the cost of transportation fees or auction fees that go into most used cars. And they can ship them anywhere in the world. So if go to newageautosales.com and see what they've got. They've got several cars over there. You know, take a look. And they're all late model and in great condition. And if you want to buy them, you can buy them in Bitcoin. Your money needs to never be exchanged into dollars. It's for late model, well-maintained cars shipped anywhere in the world. Head over to their website, give them a call, and buy a car from the first Bitcoin auto dealership, newageautosales.com. And you will be grateful that your car isn't breaking down all the time, because that stinks like my truck.
Ooh, sorry to hear that.
Yeah, the darn thing.
Ew.
All right, so toll-free number, because one of the things that happens when you buy a car from somebody you don't know, somebody who has no reputation, is you don't know what all the history was with the car. But if it was a rental fleet, you know it's been taken care of, right?
Right.
NewAgeAutoSales.com. 855-450-FREE. With you tonight, it's Ian here.
And Lauren Rumpler, a.k.a. Objectivist Girl.
And Mark.
All right, so I started the show out with what I would consider a very truncated version of a story that we've read year after year here on Free Talk Live. And to those of you who are new to the show, I know you haven't heard that story. It's a great story. I recommend you go to lourockwell.com and check out the Great Thanksgiving Hoax, because it goes into greater detail on what it is that Dick Cheatham has touched on here in his very brief summary of, you know, what's the real first Thanksgiving? Well, he alleges that it was an event wherein the people who had come here, pilgrims, were celebrating the sort of flush that they had with food. They had all kinds of, you know, surplus as a result of changing their economic system. They changed it from what was called the common storehouse system to a system of individual ownership of the land on which people were working. Because previously it was a sort of Marxist system almost.
Yeah, it really was. It was a situation
where— I don't
know
if Marx was even alive. I don't think he was.
No.
When was he, in the 1800s? Yeah, so
what they would do is they had this large area of good land, and everybody works the land, and then everybody eats what they need. And
from each according to his ability to each according to his need.
That wasn't a quote from there.
But that's essentially the system that they had.
It is and was.
It didn't matter how much work you put in, you still got to eat.
Well, that was the idea. Is remember, all these people were essentially working for the company. This is this settlement was the company doing the settlement. So these people were essentially livestock.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, you know, that's the farmer manages the food to the livestock, and you feed the sick horse along with the healthy horse.
Right.
But
you get to eat so long as there's actually food in the storehouse.
Are you implying that it's different now, that we're not still all livestock?
No, we're much more free range. And that's, you know, that's what, well, the free range chicken is responsible for going out and eating his own bugs.
I'd say if you ran away from the group, you'd be a lot better off back in that day than you would be now, because they'd find you now.
No, you'll die out in the wilderness. I mean, it's just in a state of nature, you're not going to do very well.
Not if you bring an Indian with you, they knew the land.
The they worked the land just like anybody else did. They'd move seasonally. Yeah. You know, I mean, that's how that goes. And, you know, what are you going to do?
Well, right. I mean, one of the, I forget who it was that said this, but I think they're probably right about that. The Indians, of course, were working the land. They weren't farming. They were just hunting what was out there, right? Whereas
a lot of times they were farming.
Were they?
Sure.
Okay. That's not okay. I'll take your word for that.
Well, it depends on the tribe you're talking about. I mean, you're talking about many different nations.
Some did,
some
were didn't.
Farmers, some were hunters.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, some held slaves, gatherers, or
because obviously, if you take land and you farm it, then you can get more food per square foot than just running around catching squirrels or picking berries. And so, you know, when you turn property over to an individual ownership situation, then each farmer gets to decide what to plant. They get to decide how much to harvest and what to charge for it. Whereas if everybody's just throwing into the common storehouse, which is what they were required to do previously, then they don't have any real incentive to perform, because the lowest performing members of the group were getting the same compensation as the highest performing members, thereby disincentivizing the higher performers from performing as high as they could. And that's what is summed up in the final quote here by Ralph Hamer from this Virginian settlement. Quote, "Formerly, when our people were fed out of the common store and labored jointly in the manuring of the ground and planting corn, glad was the man who could slip from his labor. Nay, the most honest of them, in a general business, would not take so much faithful and true pains in a week as he will now do in a day," saying that even the good workers under the socialist system would do as much in a week under socialism as they would do in a day under a system in which they actually own the property and they can make their own decisions.
His claim is
seven times the productivity.
I'm sorry, buddy. apparently you don't know how these things work. These people probably would have had their heads cut off if they worked on Sunday. Six times as productive.
Religion.
Gotcha.
Yeah, they moved here as to get religious freedom, so they
in
were
some,
all religious.
Some cases.
Yeah, they couldn't work on Sundays. But I actually just found an article that says there were four basic ways for people in ancient societies to find food: hunting and fishing, gathering, farming, and raising domesticated animals. And Native Americans did all of these things, but the first three were much more common.
All right. Learn something new every night here on Free Talk Live. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So that's kind of the beginnings of Thanksgiving, at least according to LouRockwell.com and some historians. Certainly a lot different from the little fantasy story they tell you in the government school system about Squanto and the corn and all of that.
Now everybody was happy.
Let's go to your calls and thoughts. Hassan is on the line in New York City. You're on Free Talk Live via Skype. Hello, Hassan.
Hello.
Hi there.
Sorry to change the topic so much, but
that's okay.
I was planning on calling in about
you don't have to apologize
net neutrality
for that.
And
you don't have to apologize for that. It's Free Talk Live.
We're
you
thrilled to hear what you have to think
and talk about anything you want. So go ahead.
Okay, this is more in response to an episode of Free Talk Live that I listened to about 2 weeks ago, and they were talking about net neutrality. So I wanted to talk about net neutrality and Title II reclassifications of the ISPs.
You do that, can you describe what net neutrality is in an easy-to-understand manner?
Yes, in like a broad sense, net neutrality is the idea that all packets should be treated equally, which means that like you pay for your own speed, the server or the service provider like that you're going to, like Netflix, they pay for their own speed. And the ISP shouldn't interfere with that speed, which basically means that the only bottleneck should be the endpoint bottlenecks. It should not be within the ISP.
And what you're talking about is the speed of the internet and the services that you're receiving. Advocates for net neutrality are saying that the government needs to come in and make sure there's an even playing field in the realm of internet packet delivery. Packets are the little bits.
If the government doesn't make sure everything's fair, who's going to?
So hang on. I'd like to give you a chance, Hassan, here to really say what you've called in about, because obviously we want to make sure we understand the terms before we go on with whatever the discussion is here. I don't want to get too technical.
Hey everyone, my Ghost 80% AR-15 project was a total success. Thank you, Guns80.com. Thank you. I bought my Ghost AR-15 at Guns80.com. It's everything I expected and more. Just got a note from my buddy Mark, and now they're having a huge Black Friday and a big Cyber Monday sale. Guess Christmas is coming early this year. I'm definitely ordering one for my brother on Black Friday because the price drops to $400. Yes, I did just say that. $400. Unbelievable. At guns80.com, the big sale is on. Begins Friday, November 22nd, and ends December 1st. So hurry now. Sale prices for Ghost ARs again, $400. Black Friday will be a good day. Get your Ghost AR-15 at guns80.com. Sale is on right now at guns80.com. That's guns80.com, guns and the number 8080.com. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas to everyone from our good friends at guns80.com. The big sale is on. I'll see you there.
The easiest thing in the world for a reader to do is to stop reading. According to the late, great Barney Kilgore, who became managing editor of the Wall Street Journal in 1941 and grew the paper's circulation from 33,000 to 1 million by the 60s. And he'd be pleased to know that his paper is one of the few that people now pay to read online. Someone else pre-internet who realized that attention is fragile? Motown Records founder Berry Gordy. In the early 60s, when his label dominated the charts, he'd bring a dozen real people into the Hitsville, USA studios and audition songs. And he'd ask, if you were down to your last dollar, would you spend it on this record or would you buy a sandwich? Today, attention span seems like an oxymoron. For tips on cutting through the clutter, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to the rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think
excuse
you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait.
Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men
working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you want. It is the live Thanksgiving Day edition of the program, as we always are. We're here, and you can dial in toll-free. The Pro XPN toll-free line is 855-450-FREE. That is 855-450-3733. We've got Skype. Skype in at username lrn.fm. Just send a contact request first. It will be approved. And then once that's approved, then it'll be easy for you to call us on Skype from that point forward. And you will sound darn good. In some cases, you'll sound almost like you're sitting here in the studio with
us.
No
way.
And the us tonight includes me, Ian.
And Lauren Rumpler, a.k.a. Objectivist Girl.
And Mark.
If you value your online privacy, you need Pro XPN. Maybe you've already got Pro XPN. Maybe you know that Pro XPN is a global virtual private network that encrypts your internet data. You can download the free app, as you may have already done if you already have Pro XPN, at proxpn.com/FTL.
You can grab it for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, Android devices, and ProXPN, again, encrypts your data connection so your internet service provider or the coffee shop that you're sitting at or the courthouse that you're on their internet connection, nobody can know what you're doing online. Your provider cannot know if you're using ProXPN. But maybe you want to get ProXPN as a gift because now's the holiday season. Great time to get a loved one something that they could use and who couldn't use more privacy in their life. You go to proxpn.com/FTL. Get started there. Use code FTL50 when you get signed up and you'll save on the annual account. You'll break the price down by 50%, meaning about $5 a month is what it'll cost for this amazing service. When you get that premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world that you can access, you can privately torrent, and get past regionally blocked websites. Plus, ProXPN does not keep records of your online habits, and you get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Maybe you want to save even more, though, and you've got some Bitcoin. Well, you can spend Bitcoin on ProXPN and get 62% off of the annual account by using code FTLBTC. So go to proxpn.com/FTL, whether it's getting it for you or getting it for somebody you love for this holiday season. Promo codes that you'll need are FTL50 and FTLBTC. It's a great discount on privacy that is priceless. We have Hassan with us in New York City. Hassan, you were calling about net neutrality, which is the idea that all packets should be treated equally on the internet, that there shouldn't be throttling of data, meaning that one company that is trying to send its data out shouldn't be given priority over other companies, say Netflix or YouTube versus some smaller website. That's sort of the idea behind net neutrality. And you were calling, we'll get to more discussion about whether or not that's a good idea or not, but I want you to be able to get your point out. I just wanted to make sure we understood what you were talking about in the first place.
Yes. So to start off, I'd like to say that when it comes to net neutrality, this wouldn't be an issue at all if there were ample competition in the marketplace for when it comes to internet service providers. This would not be an issue.
The
problem is, due to many, many years of widespread corruption, we now have monopolies and duopolies, and it's nearly impossible for a new ISP to actually start up because basically for your ISP to provide access for the entire internet, you need to be able to interconnect with the other ISPs. If they grow to a large enough size, they become gatekeepers and they can decide to simply not allow you to connect to the rest of the internet. So new competition is very hard to start up.
Right, and it's thanks to government regulations, government control, licensing makes it very difficult. Franchise agreements with local governments make it very difficult for upstarts to enter in the marketplace.
Right, it used to be that there were all kinds of other internet service providers back in the days of dial-up. There were, you know, dozens in your town because anybody would have the ability to do that on their own. But then after DSL and cable, I mean, the phone lines themselves are controlled by the phone company and the cable lines are controlled by the cable company. So you have already instituted government-granted monopolies in place in many cases.
Yeah, electricity is monopolized. And what portion of New Hampshire has no power right now and hasn't had it for like 24 hours
like
at this point?
Like 200,000 households or something like that?
Yeah, sounds like monopoly sucks.
Yeah, no doubt. So where were you going with this? Some sort of, what was the other thing? Tier 2 or what were you talking about there?
Tier 2.
Yes, it's basically Title 2 reclassification, which basically, when ISPs aren't classified as Title 2.
What is a Title 2?
It's essentially common carrier status. That's what Title 2 puts the ISPs onto. It's basically the same type of regulation that you'll find on landline phones, but the government has the option to pick and choose which of those rules that they apply. So even if it goes through, they could easily decide not to enforce any of it.
But so I'm sorry, the Title II thing is a proposal?
Ian, Title II allows for blocking sites and fast lanes that prevent new services from coming to the market.
So just to clarify, the Title II is a proposal? That's something that people want to put on the companies that doesn't already exist? I don't know anything about this.
Yeah, they want to start a Title II. And they want to reclassify it.
What you're saying is they want to regulate internet providers like the phone companies, which are ridiculously regulated, and there's like insane amounts of regulations, which is why it can cost more money to call you know, two towns over than half a country away or something like that. I mean, like the phone regulations are so Byzantine and so crazy.
I called, I can't remember, some Southeast Asian country because a friend had been stuck in an airport and I was trying to, you know, make a telephone call and see if I can, you know, do something about it. And he had asked for phone calls in this case. And, you know, like he had given the number and the expectation he had was like people would call on Skype. At the time I was on satellite internet and couldn't use Skype. Mm-hmm. So I made the telephone call. It was $80 for a 7-minute phone call.
Jeez.
And you had no idea up front, right?
Right. You have no idea what it costs to make the phone call. So on Skype, it's free or nearly free. On this phone thing, it's $80.
So you're saying they want to regulate the internet companies like the telecoms. And who's proposing this? Is the FCC?
Yes.
No, the FCC is trying to avoid additional regulation at the moment. Because there's a lot of pressure from the ISPs and their lobbyists.
Who is
the problem is that I feel that
the ISPs are pressuring to be regulated like the phone companies?
No, they're pressuring to not be regulated.
Okay.
Like a few months ago, Verizon took the FCC to court and won when it came to their regulation over internet fast lanes and the ability to throttle.
Okay.
And the reason why they won was because the FCC had no jurisdiction over the ISP because they were not classified as Title II. So I feel that Title II will be like basically the lesser of two evils in this situation, because if due to the monopolies the ISPs have, if they are allowed to even have anything remotely close to a internet fast lane, then that automatically makes the act of maintaining the non-fast lane traffic to be financially toxic.
But
these
let me ask
businesses,
you this, though.
Their goal is to make money.
Wait,
absolutely.
Are you advocating for Title II?
It sounds like he is. He said he thinks it's the lesser of two evils. Just to clarify, what you're saying is you think that if they get regulated as this Title II thing, that that's somehow better than the current situation?
At the moment, it is, because it...
But why? For all this fear-mongering I've heard, I've never had a problem, you know, going to websites. I don't think that this throttling is actually happening.
This will block sites, and it'll prevent faster internet from coming to the market, and it'll create less privacy rights, and it'll block one of the most revolutionary means of communication since the printing press.
You're saying the Title II will do that?
Yeah, Title II will do this.
Yeah, I can't
it's
say,
horrible.
I mean, how you can say that adding regulations is somehow the lesser
current,
of evils?
There are certainly some kind of regulations currently that disallow them from creating this fast lane, right?
There were in the past for a couple of years, but then once Verizon won that court case, those rules got essentially thrown out the window.
Okay.
Which is why you had the whole debacle with Netflix and Comcast and Verizon and the issue with indirect throttling.
I've got a bunch of questions.
Me too.
I guess the one that I really want to get out there is that, you know, this revolutionary form of communication known as the internet came forward to us. If somebody monopolizes it or whatever, won't somebody just provide us something new, the second tier in some way?
All right, we'll come back with we'll give Hassan a chance to answer that here in a moment. Your calls and thoughts are welcome as well. It's Free Talk Live.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The experts at Web.com want to build your business a successful website for free, just like we did for these current Web.com customers.
We've used and looked at other website designers, but there's nobody better than Web.com.
Web.com can build your website in as little as 7 days, free. Plus, we'll promote it on all the major search engines like Google, Yahoo, and Bing. If after 30 days you're happy, we'll continue to provide promotion, hosting, support, and maintenance, all for one low monthly fee. If not, cancel and pay nothing.
If you're in business today and you don't have a web presence, you won't be taken seriously.
Call right now and you'll also get a free .com or .net domain name for your new website powered by VeriSign, the world's leading domain name provider.
Call 800-297-0154. That's 800-297-0154.
No upfront charge for site build, after which ongoing fees apply. Rights to site are relinquished when canceled. Domain included during active service, after which fees apply.
That's 800-297-0154.
Free Talk Live.
Well, I'm a working police officer. I'm actually on duty in a small town in Central Texas. I've been doing this job 10 years. 99% of what you guys talk about is dead on. We got guys getting into this profession just to wear a badge and play God. It's getting worse and worse. There used to be a couple of decent guys that I worked with. Both of them have quit.
Why did they quit?
Well, it's because of the BS. We can't help the people that actually need help, which is what you get into this job to do if you're a good person.
It's interesting that whenever honest cops call in like you, we get the same story, that the corruption rises through the ranks, that the good guys, the guys like you that got in to make a difference and actually help people and catch the real bad guys, the guys like you end up getting frustrated by the system, frustrated by the corruption and the bureaucracy, and they end up quitting, which of course means that more bad guys can move in and move up through the ranks. Is anything inaccurate about that?
No, sir. That's my point entirely.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited here to take control of the airwaves. The number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you tonight, you've got Ian here. Oh, sorry, Lauren, try that again.
And Lauren Rempler, right, a.k.a. Objectivist Girl.
I swear I'm not falling asleep yet.
And Mark.
It is Thanksgiving Day.
It's all that food.
I think that is. I'm feeling a little better. I'm not yawning as often during the breaks now.
You know, I think it's because the food is too good. I think we should regulate the food.
We had some great food. I mean, we really did.
I think we should regulate it.
At the
it's too good.
Activist Thanksgiving gathering that happened here, as happens every single year up here in New Hampshire, in multiple locations. So if you're going to make the move up here as part of the Free State Project and you're wondering, you know, am I going to have friends when I get there? Not only will you have friends, but you'll have friends who will put on a really great Thanksgiving dinner. At least that's what happens in multiple areas of the state. And I think it's more than just Keene and Manchester. I believe they happen in other places. I'm just not privy to, you know, all the different options.
My favorite saying is John Connell's, what he tells people when he meets them that have moved for the Free State Project recently. He says, "Welcome home."
Yeah, that's a good one. So check out freestateproject.org.
Beautiful.
Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We've got Hassan on the line with us in New York City, and he's calling saying that he feels like on this whole network or net neutrality topic that there's a proposal by apparently the FCC.
It is by the FCC. I looked it up.
Yeah, and Asan had said it was not by the FCC, but you're saying it is.
It is. Everything I'm looking at says it's by the FCC.
The proposal is to take internet providers and put them into what's called Title II, which would regulate them as though they were old school telecom providers. That's my understanding of what's been presented thus far. And Hassan is saying he thinks that's the lesser of two evils. That would be somehow less evil than the current situation today, wherein they are not being regulated. And I can't say that I think that any kind of regulations are in any way lesser of evils. I think that more any regulation, and certainly more regulation, is going to be more evil. But Hassan, go ahead and make your pitch.
Yeah, so basically, to clear up a few possible misconceptions, Title II makes it strictly illegal to block any kind of traffic. So they can't block anything and they can't do any prioritization, like paid prioritization.
So no throttling.
Yes. It basically just completely makes it illegal if they decide to enforce that specific section of it.
Why would you want to threaten somebody with violence over...
Why would you not allow someone to pay to promote their business? It's like a It's like a billboard.
Great example. Here's a good example of that. Like from what I hear, in certain grocery stores, companies that are like the big brand name, you know, if you're on the cereal aisle, there's Kellogg's, there's GM, or not GM, General Foods, I guess, and then
GF.
Is that what it is?
I know, anyway, I have no idea.
There's the
big
other
G.
There's the other one. General Mills.
General Mills.
So there's Kellogg's, General Mills, and then there's, you know, the bagged cereals. And
the stuff you buy.
Those things are great, man.
I know, right? Malta Why do Meal? People spend all that money?
Malta Meals made it as far as a competing brand, as far as I'm concerned. But,
as far as I'm concerned, you know, they are bags of light, fluffy candy.
Your point.
But my point is that when you've got these alternative brands, they're, in some cases, the brand names are actually paying for placement. They're paying for the optimal shelf. They're paying for the shelf that's at eye level. Wherever it is that the people who are walking down that aisle are looking, that's the most valuable shelf on that aisle. And shouldn't the grocery store be able to accept money from Kellogg's to put Frosted Flakes front and center? What's wrong with that?
Yeah. It's like a billboard, except for less, you know, sky pollution.
So what's wrong with that, Hassan?
That's essentially the equivalent of you being able to pay for different speed tiers with an ISP. Perfectly understandable, because the only area where an ISP's network is actually limited is when it comes to the total capacity or the total amount of simultaneous throughput.
Mm-hmm.
So, for example, if an ISP has a 1,000 gigabit connection to the rest of the internet, then they could sell 1,000 1 gigabit connections to customers.
That's correct.
But like, and what I'm basically trying to get to is that if an ISP, like what they're currently planning on doing, which is what led to their lawsuit to begin with, was they wanted paid prioritization. So they wanted to be able to charge content producers additional money, and then they'll give their traffic a higher priority. The very existence of this means that the ISP is essentially overselling their service. A good analogy for this is, imagine that you and three other people walk into a pizza shop, you each order a large pizza and pay the full price for that pizza. But the pizza shop owner only feels like making one pizza, so he makes one pizza, cuts it into four pieces, and then gives it to each of you. That's essentially what happens now when an ISP oversells their service. They don't have enough throughput to support all of the people who want to use their service.
Won't there be, since there's competition and people don't like slow service, and the United States already has slow service on a global level. For one, I'd like to know, what do other countries do about this? Because there has to be some that that regulate it and some that don't. The other question I have is when you're talking about like, what if Facebook and Google, which are essentially the two halves of the internet at this point, what if these companies do pay these ISPs money, and essentially it subsidizes the amount of your cost? So when I had a cell phone plan, I've had cell phone plans in my life that were $150 a month, and this has been more than 10 years. But now I can have unlimited with a smartphone. This wasn't even with a smartphone, mind you. With a smartphone, I can have unlimited with for $45. So the because of competition in the marketplace, price has been driven down.
Even the limited competition that we have.
The limited competition that currently exists. But you can compete as a cell provider. It's not that difficult. I'll say that this is a little harder, but there's still competition. And so, yeah, what if that lowest tier of connectivity is just Facebook and Google paying to just get Facebook and Google to people for free?
The issue is when this happens, you are creating essentially a double-sided market where the ISP is able to double dip. Once that happens, that means that the fast lane becomes more profitable than non-fast lane traffic, which means that an ISP is not incentivized to maintain any of their interconnects. At most, they'll maintain just the bare minimum. And what you end up with
When you say interconnects, what's that?
It's basically how the ISPs connect to each other. Basically, the internet is a large cluster of interconnected private networks.
So like what you're
Verizon
saying
has
is
their
that
own
you,
network.
What you're saying is that you believe that if you know this priority traffic or whatever thing goes through in a big way, that
it's
the ISPs
happening.
Will neglect. The little guys. They'll give all the time and the effort to maintaining their connections that'll allow them to have fast traffic with YouTube or Netflix, but with the little websites like Free Talk Live, maybe not so much. I find it just really fear-based and paranoid. I mean,
it's already happening.
Actually, the professionals like Daily Finance are saying the opposite. So Daily Finance actually says for big established players, paying those premiums will be manageable, if not pleasant. But small businesses and online startups will likely find themselves in a tough predicament.
Right.
So without the ease of access and unfettered growth, these companies will likely struggle and hire few employees, potentially stunning the U.S. job growth.
So what you're saying is they're arguing for net neutrality.
Yeah, that's what they're saying.
No, they're arguing against.
No, they're not.
That's what it sounded. That sounded like an argument for net neutrality to me, what you were just reading.
Yes, that is what Hassan says.
Right.
Right there.
You're saying it's happening already, Hassan. I mean, can you give an example of that? I mean, which companies are doing this? Because I've got two different internet providers here at the LRN studios, and I've never had a problem. I mean, sure, there's some problems, some outages every now and then, but that affects almost all the sites. Or maybe, you know, actually, I had a problem the other day with Google. So it was Google that was down, and all the other websites were working fine. What's the real-life example?
Basically, a good example of this is there was, like, until recently, there was a major throttling issue with Netflix and Verizon, where basically on Verizon Fios, you'd pay for a 50 megabit connection. But if you were connected through like Netflix, you'd only get a 1 to 2 megabit connection.
That's more than enough to download a movie from Netflix.
Yeah, but it's not what you're paying for.
It's streaming.
No, well, that's
so
just it. You're not paying. Hold on. You're not paying for
anything.
You're not paying for 50 megabit connection to Netflix. You're paying for up to 50. And that's one of the things I want to come back to. You had said that these companies are overselling their service. That's not true. When you look and you buy these packages, it says up to 50 megabits, up to 30 megabits.
Yeah, I don't think I ever get my full.
They never sell you on, we're going to guarantee you 50 megabits, unless you're going to pay them through the nose for some super upper echelon level of, you know, high tier commercial service. Hey, thanks for the call tonight, Hassan. I appreciate it, but it just feels really fear-based to me, this whole net neutrality thing.
This is the one area where government regulation is going to work.
You're being facetious there. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, but there are certainly plenty of people who believe that. We'll continue the discussion in moments.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 27th, 2014. Happy Thanksgiving. Gold closed Wednesday at $1,197, down $2. Silver closed at $16.50, down 15 cents, and Bitcoin is trading around $373. Today's precious metal prices brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by eFoods Direct, redefining the way you think about storable food. eFoods Direct is offering 10% off to all Liberty Beat listeners. Just go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 and mention Liberty Beat for your savings today. In the news, Cleveland police have released the 911 call along with the surveillance video that captured the police shooting death of 12-year-old Tamir Rice, who was armed with a pellet gun.
I'm sitting in the park at West Boulevard by the West Boulevard Rapid Transit Station, and there was a guy in there with a pistol. You know, it's probably fake, but he's like pointing it at everybody.
The video was made public at the request of Rice's family. The compressed silent video shows that Rice was shot within 2 seconds of the police cruiser arriving at the playground where Rice was located. The names of the two officers involved in the shooting have also been made public. They are Timothy Lohman and Frank Garmbeck. A violation of protocols. That's what the Washington Post is reporting following a review of the grand jury testimony that led to the non-indictment of police officer Darren Wilson. Among the protocols violated, according to experts in policing procedures and Justice Department documents, was Wilson's unescorted return to the Ferguson police station, where he washed the blood from his hands following the shooting death of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Also cited as unusual by the newspaper is that the police interview of Wilson immediately after the shooting was not recorded. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Did you know you can support the Liberty Beat when shopping on Amazon.com? Just log into your account after clicking our Amazon affiliate link at libertybeat.com/Amazon. That's right. You can help the Liberty Beat continue to deliver hard-hitting Liberty news and activist updates by doing your Amazon shopping after following our link at thelibertybeat.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Thanksgiving, November 27th, 2014. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com and like us on Facebook at facebook.com/thelibertybeat. Hong Kong police pledged to keep the streets of Mong Kok open after the biggest operation in 2 months cleared in camp pro-democracy protesters. The South China Morning Post reports police officers lined roads and were last night stopping and searching people in the area and noting their identity card numbers. About 6,000 officers will be assigned to Mong Kok District until November 30th to prevent reoccupation. Reuters is reporting that Congress can block President Barack Obama from using federal immigration fees to issue permits for millions of undocumented immigrants to stay and work in the United States. That's revealed in a congressional research memo released Wednesday. The memo was sent from the nonpartisan Congressional Research Service to Republican Senator Jeff Sessions. A plan to deny such funds in a must-pass federal spending bill next month could lead to a government shutdown. Twitter users, be aware. The company is beginning to collect data regarding the other apps its users have installed on their smartphones. PC World reports that Twitter says the data will include only a list of installed apps and not any personal data related to their use. The company claims the reason behind the data collection is to provide tailored content to users. Google and Facebook already collect similar material under certain circumstances. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by My Magic Mud, detoxifying tooth powder, the most effective and affordable dental care around. Get a 150 application jar at MyMagicMud.com. Want to reach tens of thousands of like-minded listeners every day with your messenger product? The Liberty Beat is looking for sponsors for their daily news service. Support this grassroots media project while expanding your reach to a targeted market. To inquire further, visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 27th, 2014. Happy Thanksgiving. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Police in Lehman, Michigan describe a local student's recently foiled plans to commit a deadly school shooting as, quote, embarrassingly bad. Authorities apprehended 17-year-old Trent Bayer Thursday after finding him in an empty hallway struggling to load a pathetically small caliber pistol while simultaneously attempting to unfold an inaccurate map of the school. Lehman Police Chief Ethan Holman elaborated several ways Bayer's strategy could have been more effective, including setting off a homemade explosive in the teacher's lounge, executing popular students first, and at the very least purchasing some military fatigues.
You're not going to intimidate anyone by wearing a tucked-in button-down shirt and pleated trousers.
In other news, a jar of change on a dresser is sadly factoring into a number of financial decisions. A teen zebra doesn't give a shit how much you honk, it's not getting out of the road. And dad's new 20-year-old Thai boyfriend really sucks at categories. And don't forget to never, ever drink Pepsi-Cola, whose dipshit marketing team backed out of a full-page ad buy at the last minute. For more news, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
It's Free Talk Live. You're invited here to take control of the airwaves. Net neutrality has been on the table here tonight, which is funny, too, because, Lauren, you actually wanted to talk about
that.
Yeah,
that's really funny.
So Hassan called in the last hour, and he went to bat for net neutrality, which means to pass some sort of ordinance or law or statute or whatever the hell.
Be a statute.
Law. No, statute.
It would probably regulations, wouldn't it? It'd be regulations,
could be.
FCC
yeah,
regulations.
Yeah, the FCC tried.
Some sort of government.
Because they couldn't get net neutrality through as a law.
Some kind of government scribblings that will require internet providers, ISPs, to treat all packets as equal. And, you know, on its face, it seems attractive, right? Like, you know, the scare story is that, oh, my God, these evil companies, they're going to make it so that Netflix or Yahoo or whoever it is that pays them would get priority on their internet traffic. And that's supposedly, you know, being promoted as this bad thing because the little websites, they're going to be the ones that that get hurt out of
yeah,
this.
Yeah, you know, pay equality on its face looks really good. But how much
paying
more?
Paying everyone the same amount for any job?
Yeah, the thing the feminist movement's trying to do.
That sounds terrible to me.
I know, right? But some people, on its face, it sounds really great. And if you have any questions about that, you should definitely check out my video from Keenvention. We went into pay equality. It's treating women as victims. Yeah, the ladies panel. Mm-hmm. And it's treating women as victims. And the thing is that, first of all, we're not victims. And second of all, how much more empowering is it that we have to be protected by the government than, you know, taken care of by a man? I don't find that any more empowering. In fact, I think I find that less empowering because the person that's taking care of me, I actually chose them to be in my life versus the government, which just kind of forces themselves in.
You libertarians, you just always go to bat for the corporations. I mean, you're in the pocket of the Koch brothers. You're in the pocket of mega corporations. You're just going to bat
for... Who's you?
You libertarians. I'm playing devil's advocate.
Okay. All right.
You libertarians, you're just toeing the line for the man, corporate America.
For the big corporations?
Yeah.
Well, actually, this is actually harmful to small businesses,
How's
too.
That?
So I actually read the wrong thing earlier, but the benefits to businesses that flow from contracting under the current non-regulation include a stimulus from ISP investment and the opportunity to innovate. And those would be actually preserved in this current system and have been preserved because of the opposition to net neutrality.
Yeah, but this isn't an innovation. This is gouging people. They're gouging. They're trying to gouge mom and pop website operations so they can play on the same playing field with the big players.
You know, Ian, I would like you to name me one time that government regulation has ever helped a business.
Right. Well, government regulation certainly isn't aimed at little guys. But I would say
no, it just
that,
ends up hurting little guys. In the, in
well,
the
this
impact.
Is ostensibly supposed to protect
Sorry,
the little
Mark.
Guys. This the way this is
That's
being
the idea.
Sold is that this is going to treat everybody's packets equally.
When the government, who is the person who gives the monopoly on cable and telephone to companies, when the government gives a monopoly out, that's when you have to start stacking the rules on. Right?
Right, because this was a government-created problem in the first place.
Right, and that's what the government does. The government will break your leg and then give you a crutch and say, look, we fixed it. And no, let's not forget, okay? So there's these sticks that they let the telephone company and the cable companies put in the ground in mm-hmm. government land. And then they let those companies decide who's going to put the wire on the sticks. Okay, you got to have an electric company,
yep.
and you got to have a cable company, and you got to have a phone company. Now,
you
the phone
How
about things? Right.
Whatever happened with the electric company doing internet? There was some talk about that years ago, but I
don't know
if it ever happened.
I have no idea. So, I mean, this
they probably couldn't get it off the ground, kind of like the Obamacare website.
I think that this would be relatively easily solved by allowing, hey, you can have, you know, if you want to pass a law, here's your law. Here's your federal law. The federal law is municipalities must allow at least two cable companies and at least two phone companies to put wires on poles. So if you're going to regulate somebody, here's my proposal. Regulate the governments.
Mm.
Because that is where the problem starts.
Again, Ian, how many people don't have, you know, power right now because
we
have
a
monopoly?
Right. A lot of people don't have power right now. Just for those of you that don't know, you're not paying attention to the weather in the Northeast.
Why would you?
They're spending Christmas
snow.
With candles and no turkey and no
Christmas
dinner.
It's Thanksgiving right now.
Oh, but, I'm sorry. Thanksgiving.
Time warp. You're in a time warp. It's okay.
I'm in a time warp. I'm
like.
Out of myself.
I know what it's like. So, but yeah, I mean, the reason why power outages happen in New Hampshire, when power goes out in New Hampshire, it's deadly. People die. Like, same thing in Florida. If the power
it's
goes
cold
out, then people
here.
Die of overheating and heat exhaustion, you know, not drinking enough water, usually the elderly. But up here, people die because it's so damn cold. And
it's in the upper 20s right now, guys, and people don't have power and heat right now. People are freezing.
It's crazy. I mean, and so from my understanding, the reason why outages happen so often up here is because all the lines are out in the open. Apparently, the linemen's union is not allowing, there's like a prohibition on burying lines. You cannot run power underground in New Hampshire. All they would have to do to solve this problem is run the damn power lines underground, which apparently is done in other countries. I don't know where else in the U.S. it's done.
Why can't they do it?
There's a prohibition on it. The linemen's union refuses to do that job. Why would they refuse that? Because it puts them out of work. If the lineman's job is, oh, we're the guys who come fix the lines when they go down.
They'd be the guys burying them, too.
Last time, though, right? Like, that would be the last job they had, essentially.
Well, I can tell you...
that would create jobs.
As a volunteer firefighter, I am so sick of showing up directing traffic and doing all the stuff when it comes to these downed lines.
Mm-hmm.
Because now the companies, you know, the linemen may have their prohibition, but then the power company says, exactly how many feet do we have to go side to the side of these lines to maintain them? Because, you know, they want to do it. They wanted to cut the margin as close as they can. There's trees all in the lines.
Mm-hmm.
They fall. Every tree is going to grow and die and fall. And that's how a life of a tree goes. And when you're in New Hampshire where there are, I dare say, millions, maybe tens of millions of trees, They're falling all the time. And when a tree is next to a wire, it's got a, oh, I don't know, probably almost 50% chance of falling
it down.
Towards the wire and taking it down.
Because logic.
Yeah.
Or
we don't have a backup system. Oh, wait, I'm sorry. There's no incentive because it's the government and they get paid anyway.
So, yeah, I mean, monopolies suck. The government has gotten us into this situation. But, Lauren, there was a story that you wanted to bring to the table tonight.
Mark Cuban. Okay, so can I first just say that Mark Cuban is one of my heroes. I think he's a complete genius. Not only has he recommended The Fountainhead as the number one business book that businessmen should read if they're interested in going into business. I wonder if I could say business like five more times. And he is also worth $2.6 billion. He made all of that money himself. He is a self-made man. I respect the heck out of that.
All right.
He is also number 459 on Forbes' list of world's richest men, which is awesome. But he is also considers himself, and let me quote him, he said he is a less or more kind of libertarian. So
less or more?
Less is more. I'm sorry. Okay. Less is more. Thank you, Ian.
Gotcha.
Less is more kind of libertarian. So minarchist kind of libertarian.
Is that what that means?
Yes. Yes.
Well, so less is more.
Less is more. So, you know, not completely gone. So it's basically the less government you have, the better. So he could be anarchist.
Yeah,
but,
I don't know. I mean, libertarian? I mean,
I guess none is less. So I guess that counts, right?
Yeah, I would think so. I'm confused by that, but go ahead.
But anyway, the point is that he thinks less government is better.
Okay.
And he's a libertarian. But lately, he's been commenting on net neutrality. So this is really funny because I wanted to talk about this on the last show.
Okay,
and this
great guy
just randomly calls in and talks about it. So I'm super excited.
Well, so why would Mark Cuban's opinion matter about net neutrality? Isn't he a sports team owner or something like
that? He is, but he's also a business owner. He bought the sports team because of all of the money that he made in business.
Mm. And he's a Shark Tank guy.
He is also a Shark Tank guy. He's investing in so many different companies right now.
So he likes fish?
No, it means he invests in different companies. It's a TV show.
Okay.
For anybody that hasn't checked out Shark Tank, you totally should.
We'll come back
with
more here in moments. 855, 450, free. We'll see what this guy has to say and whether it matters. It's Free Talk Live. Will he be right? You take control.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today is October 29th, 2014. Gold opened at $1,223.40. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,268.34, $634.17 for a half ounce, or $317.09 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,268.34, $634.17, and $317.09.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase, and there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
Are you drinking too much and it's destroying your life? If you're ready to quit drinking, we have a real solution for you that can help you quit drinking within hours. That's right. We can help you quit drinking within hours. It's not magic. It's medical science. At Sober Time, we'll show you how this simple 20-minute outpatient medical procedure will turn off your cravings within hours. Let's face it. If you don't crave a drink, you're not going to drink. And if you don't drink, you won't get drunk. The medication is FDA approved and covered by most major insurance plans. So if you're really ready to stop drinking and get your life back, call Sober Time now for a free consultation. Patients have nearly an 85% success rate. So here's the number. Call right now. 800-659-0267. 800-659-0267. 800-659-0267. 800-659-0267.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Antiwar, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Thanksgiving Day edition of the program. Plenty of time for you with your calls and thoughts at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Some of you might be sitting down with a cup of delicious BuzzBox coffee tonight after your Thanksgiving Day meals.
This late, you better hope it's decaf.
You can water get that.
Decaf, oh, yeah, man.
You can get decaf.
Be up all night with those relatives.
Yeah, and BuzzBox's decaf is water decafed, which means that it, you know, isn't decaffeinated with all the chemicals that so Ooh. Many of the other decaffeinated coffees are.
Ooh.
That matters to a lot of people. It's 100% organic, shade grown, top 1% grade Arabica beans. BuzzBox coffees, great coffee. You taste it and you'll agree. So we're going to give you a free pound. Go ahead and go to coffee.freetalklive.com. You pay for the shipping. It is a subscription program. You can cancel it at any time. But what we do for the people that stay on the subscription is that we're able to give a microloan for every 10 people that sign up, a microloan to another family around the world. People that are looking for a hand up, not a handout, just a way to get their business up and going. We're essentially the Shark Tank here in this situation. We're helping them out.
Oh, Mark.
But there's no interest. So it's coffee.freetalklive.com. Get your free pound.
All right. Coffee. So Lauren is here with a story about a Mark Cuban. He's a football team owner or something like that.
Dallas Mavericks.
I think that's basketball.
Is that baseball? Basketball.
Basketball.
So he's got a ball team. And
count on libertarians to not know which sport we're talking
he's
about.
He's a liberty guy, apparently, and has been speaking out against net neutrality. Is that right?
Yes, he has.
What's he have to say?
So it's an article by Reason, which is obviously the one that I always go to. So Mark Cuban on net neutrality, the government will F the internet up. And he actually uses the word.
Yeah, thank you for your self-censoring. I appreciate that.
Of course. Yeah. So entrepreneur, NBA team owner, and Shark Tank star Mark Cuban has this to say about net neutrality and the push to regulate the internet under Title II of the Telecommunications Act. The government will F the internet up. He also writes in an email exchange with Business Insider, all typos in originals. Since when have incumbent companies been the mainstays for multiple generations? Cuban believes that startups blow up older companies despite an unregulated internet that allows internet providers to prioritize certain traffic streams. Overall, he thinks the current debate is too narrow and short-sighted. There will be so much competition from all the enhancements to wireless that incumbent ISPs will have to spend their time fighting cord cutting, he says. And this is a man that really knows about advancements and innovations. He started many, many companies. He knows what new advancements in technology is going on. And he can kind of, you know, people that have been doing entrepreneurship for like a long time that are serial entrepreneurs can often predict better where the future of technology is going. Because first of all, they're involved. They have friends that are involved in entrepreneurship, so they know things before
we
do.
Well, he's not going out on a limb here. I mean, this isn't isn't a really big prediction. I mean, the idea of wireless internet access.
Just people will listen to him.
I mean, this is no Bitcoin.
This is an old idea. I remember back when we were in Florida, Mark. There was a startup company down there that was offering wireless internet access
just in downtown because they had these things on the top of buildings.
You had to put up an antenna on your roof in order to be able to get it, but they would install that for you.
Yeah, yeah. But you had to clean it off during the winter because it would get snow on it.
In Florida.
Oh, I'm sorry. Don't know what snow is.
Ian had never seen snow until he came to New Hampshire.
Oh my God, what was that like? I'm sorry.
No, there was one year where there was a little flurry that came down.
Yeah, but that doesn't count if it doesn't stick to the ground,
right,
Ian.
Right.
I mean, people are chuckling at you across the nation. The simple fact that a little bit of frozen water might have flipped
around. Hey, I shovel the stuff now. I mean, I've got plenty of snow.
Cute.
But my point was that there was a company that was offering wireless internet access, and I checked them out, and you know, I was interested because more choices is a good thing. It was a little bit out of the price range.
Yeah, it was expensive.
It was kind of new at that time. Maybe it's more affordable now if they're still in business.
I don't think they are. They went out of business.
But the idea is still solid, and I think the people that are most reliably delivering that service are the cell phone providers. Right now, you can get on your, if you've got a 4G cell phone, you can get on your 4G cell phone and you can get 10 megabits a second easily on your cell phone. And you know, by comparison, your average DSL connection, the one we have here at the studio, it's only 7 megabits downstream. So my cell phone, I don't have a 4G anymore, but I got 3G now, but my old 4G phone, I'm just not willing to pay for it, but my 4G phone was faster than one of my home internet connections. So I think that the competition's already there that he's talking about.
Advancements in internet should not be a surprise to anyone. So a huge Twitter user, Cuban, also recently tweeted the following: the promise of the net is not content. It's high-speed apps that change healthcare, medicine, transportation, safety, and more. The best is yet to come on the net. Mm. And we can't hold it back because we want to make sure we can watch TV shows. We need fast lanes. Blocking access is a different animal. Where have you seen it happen?
Right. Which company is going to block companies from being able to deliver product to their consumers? I mean, whoever it is that starts blocking some sort of internet access is going to lose customers to anybody else who isn't blocking.
Yeah,
there are people out there that are going to say, I just want the Facebook and Google internet. And that's fine.
That's fine.
They should be able to pay for that, and that's okay. But chances are good, since that will be subsidized, that it will be cheaper. Mm-hmm. It will be less costly than the internet you have today. And then if you want the full-scale internet, you'll probably pay the regular price. And then if you want faster internet, just like today, you'll pay for more.
Look, business owners are greedy, and I say that in the most positive light. They want to make the most money that they can. They want to provide service to the most people that they can. Where the problems come in is where you get government involved in business, because government actually wants to discriminate against people. Businesses just want to take literally anybody that can pay the fees, and they want to keep the fees as low as possible. That way they can get more people service.
Well, right. I mean,
because they're going to make more money than if you charge a lot for a small number of people than you would a small amount for a large number of people.
That's true. And I think that it's important to remember that the only way a business can make money is by satisfying their customers. I mean, if the customers aren't, unless they have a government monopoly or some sort of government protection, protection that guarantees them business. But in a relatively open market.
Right. Government is the problem.
Yes.
They're either getting incentives to not provide for certain people, or they're not allowed to provide for certain people because government is, you know, putting the big stick down.
I don't think the advocates of net neutrality really know what they're getting into.
No, they don't.
They don't know what's going to come out of this. They don't know the unintended consequences. I mean, we know what the unintended consequences are in, like, the war on drugs or, you know, whatever other government program that we're intimately familiar with. And we can predict fairly, I think, easily some of the unintended consequences. Like, we would know that competition won't be as intense with government regulations, and therefore service may not be as valuable, that it may not be as cheap. But what we won't know is what we're missing out on. We won't know how fast the speeds might have gotten had it not been for the government regulations, or how cheap the service
might
be.
Every regulation slows us down, and that's the thing, is that, you know, the internet could be this amazing, you know, engine, and we're slowing it down. And I think that that's really important. So
we'll come back with your thoughts. You're welcome to share them here on this live Thanksgiving Day edition of Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Take control of the airwaves. Maybe you want to tell us for what it is that you are thankful. This is Free Talk Live. There's more coming up.
This holiday season, give the gift that keeps on giving, an in-home freeze dryer from Harvest Right. With your very own freeze dryer, you'll be able to freeze dry the food your family loves. Because we live in uncertain, difficult times, what better way to show your love for your family than to buy them a gift that helps them preserve food they can use now or in 25 years? Go to HarvestRight.com and find out how you can get your in-home freeze dryer. Layaway is available. That's HarvestRight.com.
Hi, I'm John Rainey, Chief Financial Officer of United Airlines, and I'm honored to be the National Chair for the 2015 March for Babies campaign for the March of Dimes. United is a proud supporter of the March of Dimes mission to improve the health of babies and fight premature birth. We're helping the March of Dimes fund breakthroughs in research and community programs that help more mothers have full-term pregnancies and healthy babies. Please join us in working together for stronger, healthier babies. Visit marchofdimes.org.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. Or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night.
from there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of Liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You're invited to take control of the airwaves here. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Net neutrality has been the major topic on the program here tonight. Of course, there's a lot of other stuff that we can discuss, including Darren Wilson, the officer who apparently shot that guy, Michael Brown, in Ferguson, which touched off a firestorm of protests and now further protests now that Darren Wilson has not been indicted. William Norman Grigg has a story about Darren Wilson, and William Norman Grigg is always interesting.
He doesn't pull any punches.
No, he's pretty great. So we'll share some of that with you here when we get a chance. I know Lauren's got more on net neutrality. Your calls and thoughts are welcome. 855-450-FREE.
Join millions of people who've trusted LegalZoom.com for their common legal documents. Incorporate your business, create a will or a living trust, even register a trademark. Empowering you, protecting you with common legal documents people trust. LegalZoom.com. It's LegalZoom.com. You can use coupon code FTL to save $10 on your order. LegalZoom.com.
All right. So we're going to get back into this discussion in a moment about Mark Cuban, who's an entrepreneur. He's been speaking out, liberty-minded, apparently. He's
Shark
been speaking
Tank
out against...
Star. Yep.
He's been speaking out against net neutrality, but we'll continue with that. First, I want to go to Rod. He's in Canada via Skype. Hello, Rod. You're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, guys. Thank you so much for taking my call.
Hi.
I wanted to talk today about a Silk Road type marketplace that has opened up, and it's called NXT Free Market.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. We've talked about that on the air.
Oh, okay. I didn't know about that. So in that case, I don't know if I'm saying anything new, but basically what is so exciting about this is that it's a blockchain-based marketplace as opposed to Open Bazaar, I think it's called, which is peer-to-peer. And when you have a peer-to-peer technology, then you have to have your computer running a node for your ad to be posted. Whereas when it's on the blockchain, you just... upload it into the blockchain and then it's there. And from a security standpoint, that's very important because, you know, if you're running a node and, you know, they raid you or something like that, then the evidence is there. So it's
Let's slow down for just a moment here. Sure. What you're talking about are methods to sell products on the internet that don't really exist yet. They're both in development, the development stages. There's some early sort of beta versions of this software out there, and I've actually tried them both out, Open Bazaar and the NXT Free Market, and they're both pretty difficult to get rolling with at the moment. I would say that NXT was a little bit more of a hassle than Open Bazaar, but not much more of a hassle. They're both a hassle to get involved with. But the idea is that they're decentralized marketplaces.
I think they've got a future, definitely.
Oh, absolutely. Oh, yeah. I'm very excited.
That's the thing, is I think technology needs to catch up to them, not them to technology. You know.
Well, I don't know what you mean by that.
I think that it's just not doable because of the current technology.
Oh, no, it's totally doable. They just haven't finished the programming yet. They just need to get the job done and get a client released that's usable to the average person. Right now, you have to have some level of
technical know-how to be able to kind of get these things rolling. But anyway, the idea is to have a decentralized marketplace. So right now we've been talking a lot about the Silk Road over time on Free Talk Live, which is an infamous underground marketplace where the FBI investigated and they swooped in and they found the server and they took it down, even though it was supposed to be an anonymous server through the Tor network. They took it down and they arrested the guy they claim was operating it, Ross Ulbricht. So the idea behind these other markets, the NXT free market you're talking about, Rod, and also the Open Bazaar, is that these are decentralized in the same way that Bitcoin or NXT or these other alternative currencies are also decentralized, meaning that there is no central server, that all of the marketplaces exist because people are participating, that those people who are participating in the market are the ones who are creating the market. They're the ones creating the network that that essentially makes the market impenetrable. It cannot be taken down by federal agents. Now, what you're saying, Rod, is that you're kind of throwing in with the NXT side because you believe that it's more secure due to the blockchain. But I would guess that the Open Bazaar guys are going to have security taken care of, too. I don't imagine they're going to just leave people's information on their computer unencrypted because from what I understand, the way these markets work is that you offer your product or service on these markets, and then it's the other people that are in the network that keep that market online. So they're probably copying over some of that information to the other people's computers. Or am I wrong about that?
As far as I know, you might be wrong, but people can correct me. Basically, yes, the information is encrypted. But for the ad to be up, as far as I understand, you have to be running your node.
I see what you're saying. So to have your store online. So when you go on the Open Bazaar, you can put a store up. You can sell Free Talk Live T-shirts or whatever it is you want to sell there. And so in order to have your store up, you would have to run a node, which presumably would be your own computer, but could also be a computer you rent somewhere or you hire someone else out to do that. And your concern is that the federal government could target the individual nodes if they could somehow identify them?
Well, I guess so. And if, for example, if your node is running, it's easier to find out where the node is.
Well, right now it's pretty clear. The Open Bazaar guys are making it really clear that at this point in their software, they don't have any anonymizing system in there, that if you're going to be selling stuff, that you should keep that in mind, that it needs to be completely legal.
Free Talk Live T-shirts, not Free Talk Live bags of heroin.
Yeah, exactly. And so I think that in the future, we're going to see more privacy protections built into these client software. But regardless, I'm excited that there are a couple of options, that it's not just Open Bazaar.
Thank God there's some competition.
Yeah, the free market guys are out there too. Anything else that you thought was worthy of sharing?
I was just wondering, how long ago did you try the software?
2 weeks.
Oh, okay. So yeah, it is fairly recent. Okay, I haven't tried it because I run Linux and they don't have the Linux line running. So
yeah.
I haven't actually run it, but there is a website called freemarketlite.com where you can see the items that are currently listed.
Oh, cool.
And it's not very many.
No, it wasn't.
It's like 30 items.
It's pretty early on at this point, and the services.
How do you spell light in this case?
L-I-T-E.
Okay.
Why don't you pull that up, Mark?
Like light beer.
Get a chance. Hey, thanks, Rod, for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you.
Thank you as well, guys.
So, yeah, I'd like to see the NXT free market be more successful, and I'd like to see Open Bazaar really, knock it out of the ballpark as far as creating these decentralized markets where, in theory, once it's done, you should be able to get on this marketplace, kind of hang out your digital shingle, and sell whatever the hell product or service you want to and be completely anonymous about it, just like you would be on the Silk Road. And not have to worry about the service being taken down. Because that's been a real hit to these online marketplaces. I mean, it hasn't stopped them. They keep popping up. There's Silk Road 3.0 now. I mean, there was Silk Road 1, then 2, and now 3. And, the feds keep arresting people. I mean, obviously, this is going to keep going. But if these decentralized markets can actually take hold, then they could kill the Silk Road model. Because the Silk Road model requires that central server for everybody to log into and for that central server to be a target of attacks. And these decentralized ones could be the real solution.
Right. The reason you can't do something like this online is so you set up this, you know, real free market on the internet. You put up a website, and then somebody decides they really do believe they're free, and they're going to sell marijuana. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, the federal government, who does not believe you're free, or some other government from some other country decides you're not free, and they're going to go and they're going to target the server. That website, they're going to get that website and figure out who's in charge of it, and then they're going to take them down, and they're going to go after the person who's providing essentially the landlord, not the purveyor of the stuff. So it's like, you knew people were selling marijuana, and it's like, well, you know, I was just providing a place where people could do business.
So there is something I'd like to continue on this for just a moment. We can come back to the net neutrality issue here in a moment. Having compared the two softwares that that exist, and not necessarily, you know, saying one's going to be better than the other in the long run, there are a couple of things that I don't like about the NXT software specifically. We'll come back with that here in moments. This is Free Talk Live.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Hey everyone, my Ghost 80% AR-15 project was a total success. Thank you, Guns80.com. Thank you. I bought my Ghost AR-15 at Guns80.com. It's everything I expected more. Just got a note from my buddy Mark, and now they're having a huge Black Friday and a big Cyber Monday sale. Guess Christmas is coming early this year. I'm definitely ordering one for my brother on Black Friday because the price drops to $400. Yes, I did just say that. $400. Unbelievable. At Guns80.com, the big sale is on. Begins Friday, November 22nd, and ends December 1st. So hurry now. Sale prices for Ghost ARs again, $400. Black Friday will be a good day. Get your Ghost AR-15 at Guns80.com. Sale is on right now at Guns80.com. That's Guns80.com. Guns and the number 8080.com. Happy holidays and Merry Christmas to everyone. From our good friends at Guns80.com, the big sale is on. I'll see you there.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial on in toll-free here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features we have waiting for you there. If you like the program, you like what we're doing here on Free Talk Live, you can shop with us. Go and get your shopping taken care of. It's Black Friday season. In fact, tomorrow is Black Friday.
And oh, no.
Tonight, probably on most of the websites.
Don't go to the store.
Exactly. That is, in fact, what I'm going to suggest that you do is stay home. Stay at the office.
Stay inside.
Go to shop.freetalklive.com and click into the Amazon link of your choice there. There are also some other stores on shop.freetalklive.com, like Walmart. Nobody's bought from the Walmart thing yet, or if they have, it's not working.
We haven't gotten a check.
I wouldn't even drive. The roads are going to be scary.
No, yeah, well, there's scary people on the roads, if that's what you mean. Like,
yeah, trying to get to other stores.
The parking lots scary. Are a nightmare. The stores are packed. You know, if you've ever been out on Black Friday weekend, you know.
Just wait for Cyber Monday.
It's a nightmare. You don't have to wait for Cyber Monday. Lauren, there are Black Friday sales online. You can go to Amazon, and they have Black Friday sales available.
You are right.
Not only do they have Black Friday sales, they've had Black Friday all week. So one of the kind of the newer things seems to be, hey, let's just make this a whole week rather than a one-day thing. And so,
why not?
So if you go to shop.freetalklive.com, there's Amazon Canada, Amazon UK, and Amazon US. You click into the right Amazon for you, and then just get your shopping done. Get the great deals. Get it delivered to your door. Buy it as a gift, you know, get the gift wrap, whatever it is you need to do. You can do it all through Amazon, and Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sales. So you get the deals you're looking for, and Free Talk Live gets a portion of the purchase. So again, please go to shop.freetalklive.com. Makes a big difference to us when you do that. So obviously we'd love to see something like, you know, we were just talking about these decentralized marketplaces. I mean, wouldn't it be great if those could replace Amazon and Walmart and things like that in the future? That'd be awesome. I don't think that's
In the future.
I don't know how likely that is in the near future, but
you're right.
But certainly when, you know, these decentralized markets come into finally get out of beta status. Right now they're beta software, which means that there's bugs. There's problems. If you download this software, it may not install and work the first time. It didn't for me. I had to, you know, tweak things and kind of, you know, check my settings.
Is that OpenBazaar or is that NXT?
Both of them. Both of them work.
Yeah, but net neutrality would kill all of this.
No, it wouldn't.
You don't think so?
No.
I think it would.
No, net neutrality just has to do with, as I understand it, now maybe another version of net neutrality, net neutrality 2 or something like that could hurt this. But net neutrality just decides packet preference on the internet. It wouldn't stop these packets from being delivered. So anyway, what I was talking about was the NXT free market is one of these open market clients. And then there's OpenBazaar. Now, Mark, you and I met the guy, one of the guys behind OpenBazaar, Sam
Patterson.
I've
met somebody who's behind NXT, too.
Oh, really? Well, that's interesting because they're anonymous.
Well, I've known somebody who's into it. How's that? Like deeply into
the NXT free market program?
Not the free market stuff.
That's what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about the currency. Okay, so the NXT thing is like a competitor to Bitcoin. It's supposed to be, you know, better in some ways. I don't believe it personally, but you know, there's all these competitors to Bitcoin. NXT is one of 400 different altcoins.
Yeah, but it has an important distinction. It's not proof of work, it's proof of share.
There's other ones that are that way too, though.
It's but it's the biggest one in that pool.
Okay, whatever. To me,
and they have a really nice interface as far as graphics go, and that matters.
Yeah. Well, who takes NXT?
At this point, I'm not claiming that it is beating Bitcoin.
It's not even close. So as far as I'm concerned, it's just one of the myriad of competitors out there to Bitcoin. And I'm sure there's some NXT fanboy pounding at their desk right now talking about how great this supposedly is.
Ian, do you think Bitcoin is going to be the hero of the world? Like,
I have no idea. But I know that Bitcoin was first to market.
Are you sold on the Bitcoin thing?
I know Bitcoin was first to market, and to me, being first to market as an innovator is a pretty big step for any, you know, company or whatever to take. Bitcoin obviously is not a company; it's a project, it's an open source movement, it's an innovation.
I see Bitcoin as just a step in the right direction. I think it's a very small step.
There may be a Bitcoin killer around the corner. I don't know.
That's just the thing. You couldn't predict Bitcoin. Nobody predicted Bitcoin. Couldn't. It was like impossible. So was the internet.
I can predict one thing, and that is that of the hundreds of competitors to Bitcoin, hundreds of those are going to be gone in a few years.
Well, that's because they're trying to replicate Bitcoin instead of actually create a new product.
Well, some of them are new. They claim that the NXT thing is programmed new from scratch. I mean, I don't know. I don't have time to audit all these things. I don't have, you know, personally, I don't have the programming know-how, the technical ability, and I'm, you know, not afraid of technology. I just don't have that ability to go in and figure out, what's the next Bitcoin going to be? Because all of these alternatives to Bitcoin are pitching themselves as the next best thing or the future killer of Bitcoin. And I guess we'll find out over time what happens there.
Another thing that can happen with Bitcoin is that somebody could create a technological overlay for Bitcoin that would then, you know, allow the product. Because, I mean, you know, Bitcoin is a huge step ahead of all the currencies that are currently used in the world that aren't sort of these online cryptocurrencies.
Sure. But it's definitely a killer of other currencies.
I think that it's, you know, I agree that it is probably going to be improved upon or replaced.
Well, it already has been improved upon. And yeah, sure. The Bitcoin protocols, what did they add? The multi-signature thing to Bitcoins where... I don't know how best to describe what that is. How do you describe multi-signature?
Well, if you want to spend a certain segment of Bitcoins in a wallet, you're going to need to have...
Someone else sign off on it.
At least someone else.
It's like the thing with the bank where you put the two keys in, you turn it at the same time. It's kind of like the digital equivalent of that, right? So they've added that to Bitcoin. So I've gone astray from my point. So there's these open markets. There's one called NXT Free Market. There's another called Open Bazaar. Maybe there are others that are being programmed. I don't know. But those are the two that I know about. And the concern that I have with NXT, there's a couple of them that I have. One, it's not operating on Bitcoin, so they're already really restricting the size of their potential marketplace there. I mean, they're already, I think, cutting their potential from the get-go with that. But secondly, the NXT situation, the NXT free market, it's not really a free market because you got to pay to list your items. So to me, that's not a free market.
Why is that not a free market?
Well, if you're paying, you know, with Open Bazaar, you can just list your items. That's a free market. With NXT, you're paying the operators to, you know, a fee, kind of like with the Silk Road or whatever, where the Silk Road took a fee. Now, the fee's much smaller with the NXT free market, but it's still a restricted marketplace. It's a market where people who don't pay
7 cents can't play.
You can't play. And so that to me, the people who are operating NXT. A free market doesn't.
So it's like free as in liberty, not free as in beer. Yeah. A free market doesn't mean that it is free. It has no cost to do business.
There's no such thing as free.
But what you're saying is that since they claim a monopoly over their marketplace, and that you have to pay to list, that it's essentially a licensing fee to some extent.
Yeah, it rubbed me the wrong way when I saw
that. Well, you hate spending money. You're so cheap you squeak, and that's not an excuse. I mean, you have to properly explain why you don't think it's a free market.
Well, maybe they'll allow anybody to sell anything on their marketplace, which would be, you know, certainly a hallmark of freedom.
Giant step forward.
But if you have to pay to get listed in the first place, that suggests that the operators are taking profits from this.
To run a business.
Again, I don't have a problem with people making money, Mark, but in this case, they're going to be running an underground marketplace, and taking profits from your underground marketplace means they're going to be much more interested, that is the feds, in taking you down. And so it's no surprise that the operators of the NXT free market are anonymous. You do not know who those people are. If you go to their website, their handles are listed, and that's it. There's no transparency whatsoever as far as who the people are that are behind the NXT free market. So, you know, that's not necessarily a bad thing, but we've met Sam Patterson from Open Bazaar. You can ask him questions. He's open about what's going on. If you want to talk to him, you can do that. These other people, who the hell are they? You know, are they going to raise the fees in the future? I don't know.
Are they the feds?
Are they the feds? That's another good question. So that's a concern for me. So the fact that it's NXT, the fact that you have to pay fees to get into
it. Well, NXT is just a cryptocurrency, so yeah. You can spend your Bitcoin on the NXT, then go and buy stuff.
True.
And so, I mean, with
you also have to install
Silk Road,
the NXT.
You had to send them your Bitcoin, did you not?
If you were to put money in an account on Silk Road, yes.
There you go. So you were sending somebody you didn't know money to hold it for you. So that's a heck of a lot worse than it being in some other cryptocurrency you're not familiar with.
Yeah, I'm just saying that, you know, it's not Bitcoin, and so they're already going to be, you know, minimizing their market potential there with that.
No, I don't think so.
It turned me off. Well, it's not Bitcoin. Well, I'll install it. I only installed it out of curiosity, just to see what was listed on there, how it was, how difficult it was. And the other problem with the NXT thing is you have to have the NXT client in order to actually run this. You have to have two programs in order to run this. You have to have the program that is the NXT network client for the software for the money system, and then you have to have the NXT free market that runs on top of that. So you've got to get two pieces of software to interact correctly and operate correctly in order
to make it work. To pay if it works.
If it works, and it doesn't work that well right now.
Well, the toll-free
number. Neither does Open Bazaar. I will say that, too. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. But I did get Open Bazaar working, and I did get the NXT thing working. It just took some time. More coming up here on Free Talk Live. You take control.
You've heard of Black Friday doorbuster deals. Well, don't miss Lumber Liquidators floorbuster deals. Get incredible discounts on your favorite floors at one-time-only prices. There's never been a better time to get a great deal on pre-finished hardwoods, hand-scraped hardwoods, gorgeous bamboo, top-quality laminates, and get 26-month special financing. Plus, get even more floorbuster discounts in our stores. The sale ends Tuesday. These deals will not wait until after the holidays. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, November 27th, 2014. Silver is trading at $16.35 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,196 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $373. Antiwar.com reports another U.S. drone strike has torn through Dahta Khel in Pakistan's North Waziristan, killing five people, all of whom were identified by officials as suspected Taliban, though none of them were actually named. The attack destroyed a house and the five people were within. The suspicion of their Taliban appears, as usual, to be based on the idea that anyone the U.S. strikes hit probably was guilty of something. It comes in the wake of another report released warning of large numbers of innocent
innocent civilians have been hit in U.S. attacks and then passed off as suspects by Pakistani officials not eager to look deeper into it. That the targets were labeled Taliban specifically also suggests that there is more information sharing with the U.S. and that the drone war is not even nominally focused on high-profile Al-Qaeda-linked targets, but any Taliban they might conceivably find. Bitcoin Not Bombs is a launching pad for nonprofits and social entrepreneurs into the financial freedom of the Bitcoin economy. Bitcoin Not Bombs offers premium publicity campaigns designed to facilitate an organization's adoption of Bitcoin as a payment system. Bitcoin Not Bombs is fully committed to being the hub of the nonprofit sector of the Bitcoin economy, maximizing the potential cross-promotion of all our clients and commercial partners. To learn more, visit BitcoinNotBombs.com. Reuters reports the younger sister of North Korean leader Kim Jong-un has assumed a senior position in the ruling Workers' Party, according to state media on Thursday, consolidating a third generation of Kim family rule in the secretive state. Kim Yo-jong, who is believed to be 27 years old, had previously only been named as a party official, but was rumored to have a managerial role in her brother's government. In a report carried by state news agency KCNA, she was identified today as a vice director of a department within the powerful Central Committee of the ruling Workers' Party. Kim Yo-jong is the only other member of the ruling Kim family known to have an official job within the North Korean government. Her brother is the third generation Kim to rule North Korea. Kim Jong-un, who is regularly the centerpiece of state propaganda, recently disappeared from state media reports for over a month, prompting speculation about alternative structures of power within the ruling Kim family. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports popular Pakistani actress Veena Malik has been sentenced to 26 years in prison for malicious acts of blasphemy after appearing in a staged wedding scene based on the marriage of the Prophet Muhammad's daughter. The wedding was part of a daytime program created and aired by GOTV. It triggered a sudden wave of controversy in the Islamic community, even though similar scenes had been aired earlier with little or no notice. The ruling by the anti-terrorism court stated the malicious acts of the proclaimed offenders ignited the sentiments of all the Muslims of the country and hurt their feelings, which cannot be taken lightly, and there is need to strictly curb such tendency. Malik, who is currently in Dubai, said she was shocked by the sentence. She told the Times of India, "We are born Muslims, and all I can say is that we have not done any mistakes, we are innocent, and that is why I'm going to Pakistan to face it. It is not a blasphemy in any way." It is unclear if the sentence will actually be enforced. The court order is to be imposed in the city of Gilgit, but control of Gilgit is shared between Pakistan and the India-claimed Kashmir region, so jurisdiction is uncertain. In any case, Malik would have to return to Pakistan to be imprisoned. Malik's husband and the chief executive of the biggest media group in the Asian country were both also sentenced to 26 years. All three were ordered to pay a $13,000 fine, surrender their passports and sell all of their property. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
It's the Onion Radio News. An area man doesn't know what to do with all the extra ketchup packets. This is Doyle Redland reporting. After finishing his Big Bacon Classic combo, Erie, Pennsylvania resident and Wendy's patron Don Turnby, 38, expressed uncertainty today regarding what to do with all the extra ketchup packets. Turnby had asked for extra ketchup upon placing his order for a ketchup-necessitating Biggie Fries.
Well, I knew it was too many ketchups because I usually only need three or four for my Biggie Fries, but I just took them anyway.
At his nearby home, the Turnby pantry is crammed with hundreds of other restaurant condiments, including single-serving packets of Taco Bell mild sauce, Arby's horsey sauce, soy sauce, McDonald's Chicken McNuggets hot mustard sauce, pats of shed spread country crock from Ponderosa Steakhouse, and a selection of Smucker's jellies and jams from several area diners. Royal Redland for the Onion Radio News, online at theonion.com.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can bring up anything you want. It is the live Thanksgiving Day edition of the program. We are here. I haven't been yawning as much since the very beginning of the show. I was so sleepy.
The tryptophan?
Things out. Yeah, I've heard this tryptophan thing is just BS.
Me too.
It's not true.
The what?
The tryptophan. It's some sort of a chemical.
But I get tired from Thanksgiving meals, and it seems to be a relatively common occurrence.
Yeah.
And I don't believe the tryptophan did anything, so it's not suggestion.
I mean,
why was I tired?
I don't know. I didn't even have that much turkey. I mean, it wasn't like I was gorging on turkey or anything.
I'm full
like that
every day. I'm an American. I eat too much. So, you know, I mean, the whole idea of a feast seems kind of ludicrous. The only thing that's changed is it's a meal of just turkey.
So the toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. Snopes.com has an opinion on this. And by the way, with you in the studio tonight, it's Ian here.
And Lauren Rumpler, a.k.a. Objectivist Girl.
And Mark.
This is an open phone show. You can call in and bring up anything that you'd like. We always have stuff to talk about here, and it is a live Thanksgiving Day edition. According to Snopes.com, the claim, now Snopes is a website that debunks or confirms various different claims that you might hear in real life or on the internet. Claim, eating turkey makes people especially drowsy. Answer, false. According to Snopes.com, most fans of the popular sitcom Seinfeld recall a subplot from a November 97 episode in which Jerry and George plied Jerry's girlfriend Celia with a dinner of wine and turkey in the hopes that the combination of alcohol and tryptophan, along with some of George's boring home movies, would put her to sleep, enabling them to play with her vintage toy collection while she snoozed.
Thus, why didn't they just ask her to play with it?
I don't know, Mark.
Wait,
I don't write these things.
It's a show about nothing.
Hold on. What? No, I have seen every single episode of Seinfeld.
I've never seen one.
Ever made, because somebody I know is like the biggest Seinfeld fan ever and sounds like Seinfeld when he talks about Seinfeld, just okay. So you know. But the point is I've seen every single episode.
And you don't remember this one?
I do not remember this episode. How is that possible?
They've got a clip here.
Apparently, what's the number?
Apparently, they attempted to drug this woman.
It was in November of 1997. I don't know the exact.
Do you know the name of the episode?
No, I don't. Well, there's actually a link here. I'll share that with you later, Lauren. Anyway, so thus did Seinfeld reinforce yet another generation of viewers the widespread bit of lore holding that something in turkey induces sleepiness, making those who partake of the bird unusually drowsy. In this instance, lore somewhat intersects with science, but not nearly to the extent claimed in popular belief. Turkey does contain tryptophan, an amino acid which is a natural sedative, to the extent that L-tryptophan has been marketed as a sleep aid. But to put an ordinarily awake person into a state of slumber, it would generally have to be consumed on an empty stomach in combination with little to no other protein, which limits the absorption of the tryptophan by the body, and in amounts larger than are typically gobbled during a holiday feast. That lazy, lethargic feeling so many celebrants are overcome by at the conclusion of a festive seasonal meal
is just fat people naps.
Usually due not specifically to the turkey on the dinner menu, but to a combination of drinking alcohol, which I did not do today, and overeating a carbohydrate-rich repast, as well as some other factors. Two other factors that
I don't think I had any carbohydrates in my meal. Sweet potato, I guess.
Two other factors that contribute to the desire to sleep at the dinner table are meal composition and increased blood flow to the gastrointestinal tract. Studies have shown that a solid food meal resulted in faster fatigue onset than a liquid diet. The solid food meal also causes...
Well, I agree with that statement. It's just I felt... I mean, I was ready for a nap this afternoon. Now, I have a six-year-old, so that's just out of the question. But I don't feel that way every other day, and I didn't eat that much differently than I normally eat, except for the fact that I had turkey instead of some other meat.
Do you not eat more at the Thanksgiving dinner, however?
I don't think so.
Really?
Not
I do.
But Ian, you weigh 100 and what? 40 pounds?
140 pounds.
Yeah, 140 pounds on a good day, right? Like, that's a full stomach, and you haven't gone poop. So, I mean, you know, your eating habits aren't representative of America, which averages out somewhere about double you.
Hmm. Well, I would think that a lot of people eat more on Thanksgiving just because there's more there. I mean, there's usually a lot to choose from, and you can come back for savings.
I think this is the United States, and a lot of people eat a lot anyway.
That's a good point. So anyway, the solid food meal also causes a variety of substances to jump into action that ultimately leads to an increased blood flow to the abdomen. This increase in blood flow and an increase in the metabolic rate for digestion can contribute to the coma. Those who still feel wary of turkey's purported sleep-inducing properties should note that many other items we commonly eat also contain tryptophan. Milk, cheese, beef, chicken, pork, and beans are among some of the foodstuffs that house this amino acid. And experts say that the average serving of chicken or ground beef contains about as much tryptophan as does a serving of turkey. If tryptophan were truly the Sandman's henchman, we'd all be falling asleep at the wheel on our way home from KFC or McDonald's. As Drs. Carroll and Vreeman note in their book, Don't Swallow Your Gum, quote, "The truth is, turkey's not to blame for your sleepiness. Chicken and ground beef contain almost the same amount of tryptophan as turkey, about 350 milligrams per 4-ounce serving. While you might have heard someone claim that turkey made them drowsy, you have probably never heard someone say that chicken, ground beef, or any other meat made them sleepy.
Nope.
Swiss cheese and pork contain more tryptophan per gram than turkey, and yet the American classic, a ham and cheese sandwich, somehow escapes blame. The amount of tryptophan in a single 4-ounce serving of turkey, 350 milligrams, is also lower than the amount typically used to induce sleep. The recommendations for tryptophan supplements to actually help you sleep are in the range of 500 to 1,000 milligrams.
So the fact that tryptophan isn't necessarily the culprit here does not mean that turkey is not necessarily the culprit. So I'm not willing to let this go today because this is a phenomenon that people experience. Plus, I would like to point out that I have tried to live my life by these little truisms that that you find, oh no, that's not true, those things. And there was another one that I read in some book or another that said that, you know, giving kids sugar doesn't actually make them hyper. And to that, I would like to say bull
ridiculous
effing crap.
Yeah.
Okay? Because, I mean, I watched the first time my son got, I'll just tell you, the first time he got ice cream, this is the Breyers ice cream with nothing in it because my wife won't
the all natural
stuff, like it's
sugar,
yeah, grated milk, vanilla, you know, that kind of stuff. And he just sat there and giggled as he ate this stuff. And I mean, just I'd never seen him act like this before in his life. I mean, I can watch it over and over again. He becomes unglued and cannot manage himself if he gets
so
too much
true.
sugar.
I remember a similar incident where I was a teenager over at a friend's house, and he had like his, you know, little cousin over, and this little guy got his hands on some Mountain Dew, and his whole demeanor changed after like one or two cans of Mountain Dew. I mean, he just was bouncing off the walls.
Well, there's a lot of caffeine in Mountain Dew too.
Well, there is that. Yeah, that's a good point.
So, anyway.
But there's also a lot of sugar in Mountain Dew.
Plenty of that.
People still feeling anxious about the prospect of tearing into a drumstick and suddenly being overcome by an irresistible urge to nod off should consider that those who took tryptophan-based supplements as sleep aids were, on the average, ingesting between 500 and 2,000 milligrams of L-tryptophan on a day. 4 ounces of turkey contains only about 350 milligrams of tryptophan, and unlike people taking the supplements who take them every day, most folks don't ingest that much turkey every day of the week. So there you go. They are claiming here at Snopes that the whole turkey's going to put you to sleep tryptophan story is just about total bunk.
Okay.
Sounds like the hairspray causes cancer thing, and a bunch of the other myths that people just make up.
There's a lot of that out there. There's no doubt about it.
Did you hear
about
the hairspray and the cancer thing?
No.
No, I've heard about holes in the ozone layer.
Right, I've heard hairspray is going to destroy the
earth. No, I heard cancer.
Well, there's a lot of rumors out there.
But then again,
verify them
everything
all.
Causes cancer.
I heard red cars have higher insurance rates because police officers are more likely to pull them over.
I think that might be not true.
Yeah, that's like,
I have a red car.
That. Yeah. Right.
The Objectomobile is red.
Gotcha.
Have you been pulled over?
No.
All right. That's actually a surprise. Seems like everybody gets pulled over in New Hampshire for
Yeah, and I'm speeding. One of the few people that haven't been. So here's the thing. I've only been pulled over once, and it was because my taillight was out. So,
Ohio?
In New Hampshire.
Oh, so you haven't pulled over in New
Hampshire. Just once, okay. Because my tail light
The toll-free number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. The cops actually pulled me over for that the other day. It was because the police cruiser's got that upper light, the one in the middle. I just tore the sucker off. Who needs that thing? We're coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
Did you know by age 50, half of all men have an enlarged prostate? This means more urges to urinate, longer bathroom trips, waking at night to urinate, or issues with sex. If this sounds familiar, call us now, because we're shipping free bottles of Super Beta Prostate to listeners of this station. Super Beta Prostate is a non-prescription formula guaranteed to reduce the symptoms of your enlarged prostate. It's yours free. Pay only shipping and handling. Just call 1-800-856-4195. In clinical trials, the ingredient in Super Beta Prostate was shown to reduce urges to urinate, improve bladder emptying, reduce waking at night to urinate, and improve quality of life. This Super Beta Prostate free offer is for listeners of this station, but it won't last. Don't wait. Just call 1-800-856-4195. That's 1-800-856-4195. Call 1-800-856-4195.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
In local news, 23-year-old graffiti artist Adam Zane has captured the heart of 19-year-old college sophomore Jessica Tisolo. Zane, who goes by the graffiti handle Slice, met Tisolo last summer at an annoyingly self-aware dive bar where the talentless artist caught Tisolo's eye with his cliched sleeve tattoos of trite Japanese imagery and the fact that he was wearing a winter hat indoors in the middle of June.
His art is really just the absolute worst. I think we're going to get married someday.
And now for This Week in Tech, brought to you by LG. An excited groom sends text messages to his buddies during his bride's vows, and a collection of VHS tapes are held onto for one more year. In other news, a burglar makes sure to crack the glass on a family portrait before leaving. There's nothing in the employee handbook about groping dead co-workers, an employee says, and a report finds that nobody's heard from David Blaine in a while, so somebody should probably check to see if he died in one of those things. Mere seconds have passed, yet we feel as though we've known you 1,000 lifetimes. For more, visit theonion.com/newsbeat.
This is the Onion News Network.
Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here to bring up anything you want at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online over at freetalklive.com. You'll like the features there. And if you don't, well, it'll cost you nothing. So go ahead and give it a try.
Everything you paid for. Right.
Wait, are you saying this is free?
Freetalklive.com? Well,
free, free as in liberty and free as in beer.
Free for you.
Wait.
I've got to pay money to run
the site. I thought there was no such thing as free.
Right, there's not.
There is, to the end user.
All right, you guys are dealing with
well, we have, we have advertisements, and you pay by looking at them.
Look, yeah, private individuals will give you free things and not steal your money. Look at that.
So, yeah, check it out at freetalklive.com. Another great website to bookmark, antiwar.com. They've got the answers, the facts, and the readership. What antiwar.com doesn't have is a pot of gold. The War Machine, of course, has the Federal Reserve's printing press and the mainstream media on their side, and all antiwar.com has is you. Their staff is unfortunately down to a skeleton crew with minimal pay. They're committed to keeping the website online with the best of the worst of all the bad news, but they can't do it for free. They need your help over at antiwar.com/donate. Give them a donation. You can do Bitcoin if you'd like. They proudly and gladly take Bitcoin as well as some other options. antiwar.com/donate, because war is the health of the state.
Paid in full by the War Machine, and the walls come crashing in.
I don't know that one.
I'm not familiar with this song.
This is Jordan Page.
Oh, okay.
This is War Machine.
Nice. I like Jordan Page.
Yeah. Jordan Page and I did some music together. You can check out my new song, Secret.
Where would one do that?
You can check that out on my Facebook page, Lauren Rumpler. So type in facebook.com/Lauren Rumpler.
That's a new Facebook page.
Actually, it's the Objectivist Girl page, but I just turned it into Lauren Rumpler.
So you changed the name.
Yeah, I changed the name.
Don't they only let you do that like URL. One time?
The one time.
Okay.
And
so you're serious about this.
I'm very serious about that. And there will be more on that this coming month.
Exciting.
Yeah.
So look for Lauren Rumpler on Facebook.
Yeah. So Lauren Rumpler. So go to facebook.com/Lauren Rumpler Productions.
Perfect.
And you're quite a singer. You do it on a regular basis here.
I do.
Don't you play the guitar as well?
I don't.
Haven't I seen you with a guitar in your hands in some picture?
Yes, you've seen me.
You're faking.
I'm a fraud. But Jordan, wrote the background song to my brand new song, Secret.
Uh-huh.
And so
he plays guitar.
Yes, and he and I are considering recording the song together.
Oh, cool.
And he may produce my album.
Oh, that's exciting.
Yeah, and you guys should check me out next. Monday night on Page Against the Machine.
What is that?
It's Jordan Page's show.
He has a show?
Uh-huh.
Everybody's got a show these days.
He does.
Good for Jordan.
Good for him. Good for
him. And of course, check out True Objective, my show on the same network, LMR. I know. Mm-hmm.
What is LMR?
It's one of
Liberty
the
Movement Radio.
Of competitors to LRN.fm.
Mm-hmm. And that'll be Monday nights at 8 to 9.
Which, of course, is not an option because you should be listening to Free Talk Live at that time. But you can always listen to Lauren's show later on at some other time. Because you podcast the show, right? Is it available in
downloadable form? I do. But
you do
I
not
think,
have to listen live.
But you podcast too.
That's true. But we're more fun to listen to live because you can actually call in. Can you call your show?
Yeah.
You can? You can call your show?
No, you can't call into my show. But we teach you cool stuff about history, politics, philosophy, money. Right now, we're going over the presidents from least deplorable to most deplorable.
Really?
Yeah.
Based on what measure?
Based on liberty. So the amount of liberty they take away from you.
Who was the guy that died real fast? I've heard he was the best president.
Actually, the best president is Coolidge.
When did he die?
I don't know. Not quickly, but he's actually really great. He vetoed almost everything that came through.
Yeah, Calvin Coolidge is probably the
most libertarian president.
Arguably the most libertarian president out there.
Yes, a lot of people think that it's Jefferson, but it's not.
1800s?
It would have to be late, or it would be early
1900s.
I would think early 1900s, because he's depicted with a straw hat, so just like Woodrow Wilson. Hmm. So I imagine it's somewhere around Wilson's administration.
Need to bring back the straw hat.
He was 1923 to 1929.
Okay. So you can bring up anything you want. We were talking about net neutrality earlier tonight. Lauren, I know that there might have been something else you wanted to add into that discussion. You had been talking about Mark Cuban, who is apparently a ball team owner of some sort. He appears on a show called Shark Tank. Is it Shark Tank Nation? I've heard advertisements for a Shark Tank Nation.
No, I don't know what that is.
That's a different show. You were saying there's another one called Shark Tank?
Shark Tank.
Huh. Okay. So
Shark Tank. Hoo ha ha.
Is that the theme
Actually, it's Shark Bait, Hoo Ha Ha. But that's from Finding Nemo. Don't mind me. I'm all over the place right now. So anyway, yes, back to the Mark Cuban Reason article.
What else did he have to say about net neutrality?
So in addition to a heavy dose of Brio, Cuban brings a future orientation that is...
What is Brio?
Sounds like cheese.
Yeah. Brie.
Brio. I don't know.
How do you spell it?
B-R-I-O. Brio.
Okay.
Whatever.
I'll check that out.
Yeah, you should. Tell me what it means, because expanding vocabulary is a good thing. And we teach you stuff like that on my show every Monday night.
It's Italian food?
On
Apparently,
LMR
we're going to teach you that here.
From 8 to 9 p.m. on True Objective.
Brio is Italian for great energy and confidence.
Oh, nice.
Enthusiastic vigor.
Okay, so in addition to a heavy dose of Brio, Cuban brings a future orientation that is typically lacking in discussions of net neutrality, Title II reclassification, and related issues. It's an accident that cable companies morphed into ISPs, and it's no accident that they were once given monopolies by money-grubbing municipalities. There's no reason to believe that cable, much less fiber, will be the way the internet is delivered even in the near future, much less the medium future. And I think Cuban, who has made his big money from the sale of broadcast.com about 10,000 years ago in internet time, is right to emphasize that what we think of as central now, video streaming, Netflix versus Comcast, torrenting, will be trifling in the future. The FCC specifically and governments generally have never been great at managing innovation.
No, they're terrible at that stuff.
I know, right?
It's laughably terrible.
They disturb innovation.
I know. All they do is hold it back.
They hold it back for decades in some cases. Like the cell phone. You could have had cell phones in the 60s, from what I understand.
Yeah, and we could have flying cars right now. It works.
Well, that's not the FCC.
But I'm way down that skateboard.
Disincentivizing innovation.
It's the FAA that's
I'll do an article on why government disincentivizes innovation if you check out objectivistgirl.com.
Okay.
It works better when they stand aside and let it happen, as mostly happened with regard to the internet and the web in the 1990s. Really, they couldn't stop it. It really wasn't about that they stood back. It's that it came so fast and it was so big.
That's right. They don't know what it is.
There was no way of stopping it.
They still don't understand it. I mean, you listen to the politicians talking about it.
Yeah. Bitcoin's the same way. They didn't know what to do about it for years. This is
Bitcoin's the same way.
New York regulation.
The Federal Reserve Bank of New York.
What's the bit license? So the bit license is the real first general attempt at.
I went to Bitcoin Not Bombs and I got an intergalactic Bitcoin license. I don't need New York State's one.
I've got one of those too. They're pretty cool. Bitcoin Not Bombs.
It's fully inclusive. It covers the whole galaxy.
What about the universe, though?
At this point, I haven't been outside of Earth.
There's
so
more
what
coming
do I
up
care?
Here in moments. This is Free Talk Live.
Are you ready to surrender your right to buy body armor? No joke. Congress is now trying to outlaw civilian body armor. And if House Bill H.R. 5344 becomes law, you can kiss your right to protect yourself against rifle bullets goodbye. Don't put off your body armor purchase any longer. Go now to InfidelBodyArmor.com. Thousands of military veterans trust their lives to Infidel Body Armor. You should too. Spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
The average family has 3 days of food in their pantry. Don't get caught with your pantry down this winter. Get 3 weeks of food free with your purchase of a 3-month supply of Go Foods now through November 30th. Call 800-648-9753 or order online at www.storefoodnow.com. That's 800-648-9753 or www.storefoodnow.com.
We're probably going to advertise.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Phone records, financial and location data, Prism, Tempora, X-Keyscore, Boundless Informant. Hey, y'all, Scott Horton here for offnow.org. Now, here's the deal. Due to the Snowden revelations, we have a great opportunity for a short period of time to get some real rollback of the national surveillance state. Now, they're already trying to tire us by introducing fake reforms in the Congress. And the courts, they betray their sworn oaths to the Constitution and Bill of Rights again and again, and can in no way be trusted to stop the abuses for us. We've got to do it ourselves. How? We nullify it at the state level. It's still not easy, but the Off Now project of the 10th Amendment Center has gotten off to a great start. I mean it. There's real reason to be optimistic here. They've gotten their model legislation introduced all over the place, in state after state. I've lost count, more than a dozen. You're always wondering, yeah, but what can we do? Here's something. Something important. Something that can work if we do the work. Get started cutting off the NSA support in your state. Go to offnow.org.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
$5, $10, $15 at a time. They left you some lump of cash. Congressman, good habit.
This is Free Talk Live. You can take control of the airwaves at 855-450-FREE. That is the toll-free number. Tonight, we're here live on this Thanksgiving Day edition of the program. Of course, we're still here to take your calls about anything, even though net neutrality and other technical kind of topics, it's turned into tech Thanksgiving on Free Talk Live here.
No, education. Yay!
But it doesn't have to be that way. You can bring up anything you want, and you can join us online over at freetalklive.com. We've got Skype. Skype on into the show at username lrn.fm, so feel free to reach out to us that way. And gold and or silver. These are fine alternative currencies.
Ooh, shiny.
Unlike Bitcoin, which a lot of people are uncertain about, gold and silver, they've been around for a long time. They got a track record.
And it seems almost certain that silver is going to go up. It's sitting at quite a low price, not a historic low, but certainly quite low. And you can go get some at gold.freetalklive.com. We've got all kinds of coins that are picked out right there for you. And go get them. Or you can use the telephone number. I can give that to you. It's there at the website at gold.freetalklive.com. It's 877-857-9938. Now, you may want to get metal for an investment or as a hedge against inflation or as a barter currency, but whatever your reason, go here to gold.freetalklive.com, 877-857-9938, gold.freetalklive.com.
You know, Mark, you should really be advertising that to objectivists since they all have a metal fetish.
Libertarians, too.
Mark, coming up, you have a story about some parents who did a home birth, and did you do that, the home birth thing?
Well, it was called a home birth, but it was at a birthing center.
Okay, but not at a hospital.
That's correct.
You did it outside of the typical means of giving birth.
My wife did, yeah.
Right. You were there, though.
Yeah.
You're like, I take no credit for
that. It was the most traumatic experience of my life.
Did you faint?
No, I didn't faint.
Did you almost faint?
It was, I didn't feel like fainting, but I was really, you know, it was really something.
Okay. Yeah,
It's funny just, watching your face when you're recounting that, too. You can't see that at home.
No.
It's really something.
I have one of those things, and I think about that, and I don't really want to... No kids.
Yeah, I heard you there, and I would probably feel the same way if I were in your shoes. One of the reasons why I got a vasectomy at age 23, because I do not want any children that I don't want to decide on.
Yeah, I'm thinking I'm probably just going to either have them carved out of me or be really knocked out.
So, Mark.
I'm sure they have a solution for you.
Do you have a story about some home birthing parents whose child has been taken from them?
Yeah, this one comes from medicalkidnap.com.
Oh my God, there's a whole website dedicated to this.
Well, unfortunately, this happens on a relatively common basis, is that, you know, the hospital decides you haven't done a good enough job. All three of their babies have been taken away from them and placed in the care of strangers. Levi was 10 months old when his mother, local singer and songwriter Erica May Rango, gave birth to his twin brother and sister at their home in Bellingham, Washington. "Our birth was glorious," she said, "and the twins were reportedly healthy, full-term babies who had no problem quickly figuring out how to breastfeed. The little family was overjoyed until CPS stepped in to help." It is another medical kidnapping, according to the parents. The Ringos have chosen a wholesome, holistic lifestyle based on their Christian faith. But CPS has stepped in to override the parents' decisions. Now Erica and Cleve are living what they call a nightmare. This is absolutely a nightmare. There is nothing. Yeah, this is a nightmare.
Losing your kid? Yeah. Yes. That's what all parents fear, right?
Right. Separated from their children for reasons that don't make any sense to them at all. It was only natural for Erica to choose a normal, family-centered birth. Erica herself was born at home and says that her mother was a home birth educator at La Leche League leader, and that's a worldwide support education system for breastfeeding mothers. And I can totally imagine what this is like, because I've heard the reports over and over that CPS or whatever it is in whatever state you're in, the Child Protective Services, that they don't make it very clear to you what you have to do to get back into the good graces of whomever in order to get your kids back.
They don't. And you know who is a CPS whistleblower is Carlos Morales from Truth Over Comfort. He actually just released a book. If anybody out there is dealing with Child Protective Services right now, I recommend that you read this book. It's called Legally Kidnapped: The Case Against Child Protective Services. And this is, he is like the only CPS whistleblower that's ever, you know, really out there at this point and has written this kind of book. So you guys really need to check this out if you're having any issues with CPS.
No, we've had him on the show. He's
fantastic.
Informed guest, that's for sure.
Legally Kidnapped: The Case Against Child Protective Services by Carlos Morales. Check him out. In fact, I hope that he does something on this home birth thing.
She and Cleve chose a birth center birth with their first baby, but decided to birth at home for the second time. She knew that her body was perfectly designed to work for birth. She believed this was the direction God was showing them for the birth, and Erica was very careful during her pregnancy to watch her diet and exercise in preparation for her birth. She read, researched, and prepared. And I can just remember what my wife did. You know, I see her prepare for marathons.
Obsessed.
Her preparation for marathons is nothing compared to what her preparation is for this. And, you know, it was a really big deal to her. She describes her home birth as exquisite and empowering. Morna Kai Grace and Danielle Clemente were born into their parents' loving arms. The birth was perfect. There were no complications.
Twins?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was a male-female twin.
Gotcha.
No complications with the birth or afterwards, but Erica and her husband Cleve had to agree to notify the local paramedics
an
effort to appease concerned family members who were fearful for their decision to birth at home. That's where the problems began. What do you bet these are the parents, by the way? The mothers.
Wait. Oh, as far as the family members, they had to notify? Oh, we want you to call the paramedics just to let them know. Right? That's what they had to do? Give them a heads up, hey, we're having a birth, but we don't need you? That's what they were supposed to do?
That was the idea.
Oh, God.
Sometime after the babies arrived on October the 2nd, paramedics arrived to find the twins nursing and everybody doing fine. The twins weighed over 5 pounds, and the paramedics allegedly verified that everyone appeared healthy. The paramedics allegedly recommended that they go to the hospital for evaluation, which is standard for EMTs.
Recommend.
Sure. The Ringos say they declined, telling them they didn't want to go to expose their newborns to the dirty environment of the hospital. Mm-hmm. They were planning to follow recommendations that they had found.
Here, kids, have a case of MRSA.
Yep. Which was that they stated the newborns should stay home for the first 6 weeks of life to give their immune systems the opportunity to build up. I absolutely think that's fine.
Okay.
I mean, that makes perfectly good sense. You don't want to do a lot of traveling. Mom is, you know, wore out for, you know, like, severely.
Especially if you did a natural birth.
A natural birth of twins.
Yeah.
At home.
Oh, God.
Two for the price of one.
God bless this lady.
You couldn't get me to do one. This woman is a hero.
All right. So the paramedics didn't seem like they caused any problems. What went wrong?
Yeah, what went wrong?
The parents believe that because they chose not to go to the hospital at the time, somebody called CPS. A couple of social workers showed up the next day and wanted to see all the children. CPS told Erica that they were here to help.
Go to hell.
Yeah. But
here to help.
Erica says
with
they were.
What?
That was not what happened at all.
When has it ever? I mean, maybe there's a few cases, but man, these people are the worst form of meddlers.
Yeah, really. I mean, if there's anybody you should not let in your house, it's Child Protective Services.
Yeah.
I would recommend letting cops come in and look around. Show them your bong before you let CPS come into the house.
Don't let them in your house.
Because
and
these
don't
people
tell them anything.
Are dangerous.
They are. So did they take these kids?
When the social worker found some eczema on Levi's skin, Erica told her that she was treating it with some herbal remedies, including comfrey and calendula, as well as applying coconut oil and giving probiotics. Remember, nothing works on eczema anyway. She was also doing emulation.
Elimination diets. Hold on. Before you continue the story, we'll get to the rest of it here in a moment, but how creepy the idea that total strangers show up at your front door and demand to examine your children, and then they start looking at their body parts and touching them, presumably, or who knows, you know, just observing closely and, you know, can you take off their shirt? I mean, who knows how crazy this gets? 855-450-FREE. More coming up. Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com. Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
With autumn in the air, it's time to think about getting ready for winter. And it's time to save at HerbalHealer.com. You'll find amazing seasonal savings to prepare you for the fight against cold and flu season. Like Oregacillin to promote lung health. 30 capsules, regularly $34.95, now only $25. HHA Olive Leaf, a natural antiviral, normally $16.95, now 60 capsules are just $12. HHA Elderberry Power, a great flu and virus fighter, regularly $16.95, 60 capsules, now $10. Save on all our homeopathic detoxes. Choose from lungs, kidney, liver, brain, libido, or whole body, normally $26.95, now just $20. Visit HerbalHealer.com and click on the Fall Winter Specials button to save on all our natural cold and flu fighting products. Also, explore our Herbal Healer Academy correspondence courses that teach you how to handle your health naturally. HerbalHealer.com, healing the world with nature, one person at a time, since 1988.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's
the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadadi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can take control of the airwaves toll-free at 855-450-FREE. It's the live Thanksgiving Day edition of the program. Talked a lot of tech tonight, but now we're talking about straight-up kidnapping when done, performed by the CPS or whatever the collection of letters happens to be in your state. It's usually different, like DCYF, Department of Children and Families or something like that, or DCF or CPS, etc. So these people, they make it their business to get into your business in your home. And Mark, you're telling us a story about some parents who, they did the home birthing thing. They did a first they did a birthing center for their first kid, and then the next birth
they liked
did.
It so much they decided to have the twins at home.
At their home. Well, I guess they felt more comfortable the second time around, and you know they didn't need the pros helping them out, at least in that location. So they had the kids, and then how long after it they had the kid did the CPS show up?
I think it was the next day.
So apparently somebody snitched them out, and the CPS shows up at their door demanding to inspect their children.
Yes.
Now, Mark, you wouldn't let them in, would you?
No.
Why anyone lets these people into their homes and into their lives? I just don't understand. It
because
must
it's
be
authority.
Just total, right. It's total obedience to somebody with a badge, somebody with a name tag.
Indeed. I don't understand.
It's so scary.
So the social worker comes in, starts poking around. The older child, Levi, has a little bit of eczema on him, on his skin, and the mother's trying to, you know, treat it with herbal remedies, comfrey, calendula, coconut oil, probiotics. She's also doing an elimination diet to locate what could be causing the skin condition. Mm. And consider that eczema, really common, and it's not easy to get rid of on
babies?
Anybody.
Or just, on people.
I don't know who it's common on, but it's common on people. So, you know, I don't think that this is nothing to be alarmed about, right? Yeah. It's a skin condition.
But the bureaucrats were concerned.
So even though it was in the healing process, well, I don't know about that, the social worker became critical that Erica wasn't treating his eczema with steroids, a treatment option that Erica wanted to save as a last resort because of the side effects.
So, of course, the sort of naturopathic or these parents here who are obviously not interested in the sort of allopathic medicine system, the hospital and doctor system, they've gone through great pains to avoid that system. Now they've got these bureaucrats who, of course, their first recommendation is, well, you need to do it this way, the accepted medical way, which of course is anathema to what these parents actually want.
Right. The CPS agent later, now consider every treatment requires a period of time to work. Mm-hmm. So she's treating, and usually these natural treatments, usually they don't work, but the times that they do work, it takes a little time. I've had things like this work for me, and you can't tell me any different. They worked.
My Magic Mud.
My Magic Mud. Yeah, I guess it's natural. It's all natural.
I use Magic Mud.
My Magic Mud. Yep.
Wonderful. It makes your mouth feel so clean.
Yeah, I can't live without it.
There you go.
The CPS agent would later testify to the judge that Erica had neglected to treat him completely.
Mm.
Even so, the eczema was the only thing wrong, Erica says. Right away, they found out that our children were not in danger. The twins were completely healthy. The house was clean. There were no drugs or alcohol involved. The Ringos agreed to take the children to a pediatrician who said the babies were doing fine. The only concern was that the twins were slow to gain weight. And this is something that people are always concerned with newborns. It's just the way it is. I mean, you know, everybody's always concerned. As long as the child isn't vegan, you know, the parents aren't vegan, I don't think there's too much to worry about. They're going to gain weight the way they gain weight. But, you know, I mean, some people are going to be at the bottom of the bell curve. Some people are going to be the other side of it. So, nonetheless, she was, at the time, Erica was trying to maintain a supply for 3 breastfeeding babies. That is a problem. She says that she followed the pediatrician's advice to supplement with formula. What else could you do? And the babies promptly got back on track with weight again. That was allegedly verified by a nurse sent out by CPS to check on them. Erica May and Cleve are holistic in their approach to life and health, preferring natural alternatives like herbs and diet changes to medical treatments. Those things appear to be options only if CPS is not involved. On November the 6th, let's go back here. I think it was October that the birth occurred. I just want to make sure that I've got the dates right. I think it was October the 2nd.
Do you know where the story's coming from?
Yeah, chance? It's medicalkidnap.com.
Oh, that's right, medical kidnap, because this isn't the only time.
What a nightmare.
That something like this has happened.
The fact that there's a location where these things are listed just speaks to the level of the problem that CPS really causes.
If you can't find the date, Mark, I say skip it and keep telling the story.
Yeah, I can't find the date off the top of my head. October the 2nd.
Was the birth, so about a month later?
Yeah.
Okay.
So CPS takes custody of the children on November the 6th. CPS showed up at the front door while Erica was softly singing and playing her guitar to the resting babies. When she checked the door, they told her that they were there to take her children.
Oh, my.
Citing neglect for not giving Levi steroids for his eczema and the home birth without medical prenatal care with the twins, as well as the allegations of abuse, accusations with which Erica had already assured them were completely unfounded. She also had prenatal care, just not with a doctor. I don't know. I don't, you know. They didn't mention the allegations of abuse up until this point. Maybe it's remember, there's family members involved. Mm-hmm. It's always a family
member. Busybody family members who were upset that they were having a home birth in the first place.
With one baby on her back, the frightened mother fled out to the back door with her children to a neighbor's house, but the police and CPS hunted her down and took all 3 breastfed babies from their mother's arms. The twins were 5 weeks old. Erica broke down into sobs.
And, of course, no one bothered to pull out a video camera and actually record
this.
She's
lucky that the cops didn't kill her. I mean, how many other instances where you can run from an official and live?
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't happen too often.
You know, if an individual had broken into her home and had taken her children, it wouldn't have mattered. But since they have some strange title, she couldn't do anything about it. And now she's separated from her loved ones.
That's horrifying.
Yep.
I mean, can you imagine a worse thing than having your children taken away from you?
So this is this year? This is fresh?
Yeah, well, this is fresh as it could be, yeah. So Erica broke down into sobs as I spoke with her. My children were safe and healthy with me since they have been taken by CPS. Daniel has reportedly had pneumonia, and Levi has reportedly been diagnosed with behavioral problems because he screams and cries all the time. No doubt.
Wow, it's not around his mother, so that could be a factor, right?
He's screaming and crying, Erica says, because he wants his mom and dad. Of course, they're going to drug him in order to prevent him from doing that. And let's not forget how many kids have been put into the foster care system
and then
been abused or killed.
Raped.
There's a story not too long ago of a father in I think it was in Colorado, where it's legal to smoke marijuana. The kids were taken because he's a marijuana smoker and put into a foster home, and the foster mother killed the kid.
It's amazing.
Children who have allegedly not been abused in any way have been taken by CPS from loving parents for reasons so flimsy that has left the Rangos and their friends stunned. Several of their friends write that Erica is a great mama. This is not the right thing to do to mothers and children, Erica emphasizes. If they thought that we needed help, they should have brought help in, not taken the children out. They have suffered, and I have suffered since our separation. Now, the difficult thing here is we don't know what happened with this lady. We don't know what's going on in this family.
I don't care. It's none of my damn business.
Well, and the difficulty is you know when you give a government bureaucracy, which is not the government, isn't known for their efficiency. When you give them the ability to take people's children away, they're going to take some people's children away that they shouldn't have taken away.
They're
going to
take rather than not, right? Like they're going to err on the side of taking.
Well, that's what the agency's for, right? Yeah. The agency's for taking kids.
And
ultimately,
how do you get them back? What does she have to go through? What kind of hoops does she have to jump through in order to have a chance at seeing her kids in her own home in any reasonable amount of time?
They don't go into that in this article. And it's really a difficult question.
You know, what would be really good is if we show support for her. I think that we should change our profile pictures to something that supports her, that allows us to
gee, thanks. Someone
to kind
changed
of say,
their profile picture.
No. Here's the thing. If we raise awareness about it, the fact that this woman has lost her kids.
What about all the other people who've lost their
kids? That's the thing, is that information can save lives. And that's the thing, is that maybe the information being out there will bring these kids back to her. And so if we raise heck about it, then maybe we can say to CPS, like, this is unacceptable, and they'll feel so much pressure they'll have to give the kids back.
Belknap, Washington.
Belknap. I thought, okay.
Am I pronouncing it wrong?
Can you post the link to this on Facebook?
It'll be on Facebook.
Okay.
Facebook.
Guys, try and, you know, shows.
Bellingham.
Put this out
Bellingham.
There.
Okay,
let people know this is going on. This is something you're going to want to share.
But this is going on in more than just Bellingham, Washington. This is going on all across the country.
But that's just the thing. If we take a stand once, it sets a precedent.
I don't know if it'll set a precedent. I mean, CPS has been screwing people over for decades.
Do you have a better idea?
Well, I think that we can have some effect if we focus our efforts in one place. So people who love freedom should move to New Hampshire, and then we can actually come to people's aid. And then we have people who know better than to just let the bureaucrats show up and do everything. Like, turn them away at the door, grab a video camera, refuse to cooperate. I think getting that information out to
parents
could
be very helpful. Time to shut down CPS.
Very helpful. Well, that'd be nice, too. But that's a legislative thing. We'll see you tomorrow night. FreeTalkLive.com.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Are you tired of governments around the world killing innocent people? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin is money that cannot be inflated or controlled by any state. By continuing to use their money, you're perpetuating the killing. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available to you now. Learn it, use it, spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. It's weusecoins.com. Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
The latest episode of Peace News Now is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, November 27th, 2014. Happy Thanksgiving. Gold closed Wednesday at $1,197, down $2. Silver closed at $16.50, down 15 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $373. Today's precious metal prices brought to you by Midas Resources.